afternoon, everybody, and welcome to Husky Stadium in Seattle, Washington, where the 3-0 Colorado Buffaloes will take on the 2-1 Washington Huskies. ABC's college football is being brought to you by Honda, who invites you to test drive the all-new Accord at your Honda dealership starting October 5th. By Michelob Drive, bold taste with no aftertaste. McDrive refreshes completely. By Shure, try new Shure Outdoor Fresh Scent. It's as clean and fresh as all outdoors. And by USF&G. All across this country, USF&G protects your business, home, auto, and life. USF&G covers the USA. As I said, welcome to Husky Stadium, everyone. I'm Tom Green, along with Ron Zappolo and Dave Logan. An interesting broadcast for us today, being on Channel 9, game being produced by Channel 4, and welcome to KUSA, fellas.
Tom, thanks very much. I think this microphone kind of says it all. 9 and 4 working together to bring this game to you, and I think we can say that we're happy that the two stations were able to come together and do this. Now we got a football game, Tom, and a good one. Colorado on the road for the first time this year, probably their stiffest test to date.
Not only getting tested by going on the road, but they're also going to be facing a fine young quarterback in Kerry Conklin. He takes the short drop back, gets rid of the ball real quick. He's a very difficult guy to defend. Now, CU, of course, has their own fine quarterback, Darian Hagan. He's done nothing but great things so far for the CU football program. He's run the ball well and has thrown the ball effectively, and Washington's going to have their hands full with him.
Speaking of CU, Dave Logan, obviously the question around the Buffs, how will they respond to the developments of the past week and the passing of Sal Aunese?
Well, Ron, I don't think anybody knows right now. I think it'll be clear after maybe a half of football. You would hope that the kids will be able to put the tragedy behind them and come out and play hard, but you really can't tell. Also, they've had 2 weeks off, 2 weeks to prepare for Washington. Sometimes that is fine. Sometimes that works to the detriment of the team that's had a week off.
Well, we're about to find out. Stick with us. We'll be back for the start of this afternoon's game in just a minute.
Little muscle in your car. Forget your old routine. You gotta pump up. Pump up to Super Clean Premium. Performance power from Phillips 66.
Back on the shores of Lake Washington, Ron Zappolo, Dave Logan, and Tom Green, as we're a couple minutes away from the start of this afternoon's game. Fifth-ranked Colorado at 3-0 versus 19th-ranked Washington at 2-1. They are 21st Associated Press, 17th UPI. And, of course, the big moment in the game will come in just a minute when we have a moment of silence here for Sal Aunese. The series record between the two teams, Washington, 3-2-1, last meeting, of course, the 85 Freedom Bowl, where Washington beat Colorado 20-17. Kind of a normal day, fellas, here in Seattle. It's cool, temperature in the high 50s, low 60s, but there was a light drizzle about an hour before game time, but it appears to have cleared up, and we should have a clean track here on the artificial turf.
You can see the entire Colorado team more or less going out for the toss. This is going to be an emotional group today. It's going to be hard to measure, like you said in the open, Dave, how the emotion will affect this CU team. There's been such an outpouring of affection towards the team and the family of Sal Aunese. Everyone from President Reagan. Last night in the team hotel, I ran into a couple of former Colorado State University players, now with the Seahawks, Kelly Stauffer and Harper LaBelle. They were coming by to give their best wishes and some flowers to Coach McCartney and the team. And this is just going to be a powerful, emotional, especially at the start, football game.
No doubt about it. I think the entire state of Colorado and more than that, the nation has been touched by what's happened in Boulder this past week. And again, I don't think you'll be able to gauge as to how this team will respond until well into the second quarter. Looked a little bit lethargic during the course of the week. The practice was not as good as you would have liked. Bill McCartney of course, assume that it might not be. But I think once the game starts, at least we hope that this team will come out and play the way that Sal Aunese would have hoped they would play.
Colorado,
be good football.
Dave, Colorado won the toss. They'll receive. And here comes a moment of silence for number eight, Sal Aunese.
In memory of two college football standouts that passed away in the last week. University of Washington was sacked by the loss of Chuck Long, captain of the 1936 Huskies squad that played in the 1937
see the whole team gathered at midfield there, and obviously a gesture for their teammate Sal Aunese. They've set their goals high. They're planning on being number one.
An emotional moment. Team has number eight on all the lockers here in Seattle. They've got number eight on all the towels they're using today, and they'll have number eight on their minds for more than just today. They'll have it on their minds throughout this 89 season.
Talking about football, Colorado comes into this game with a big edge in the kicking game, and the fact that they're averaging about 39 yards a kick return against a special teams unit for Washington that really hasn't impressed so far might allow the Buffs to get off to some good field position right out of the gate.
John McCallum, fine kicker for the Huskies, will kick off. Colorado 3-0. Looking to move up in the rankings. Colorado has beaten Texas, Colorado State, and Illinois. Washington beat Texas A&M and Purdue. They lost last Saturday night on a late field goal down in Arizona, 20-17. Pritchard and MJ Nelson are deep. Nelson is 18, Pritchard is 9. Nelson third in the country in kickoff returns, averaging 39 a return. So an emotional CU football team takes the field, and we're underway in Seattle. This one loose on the carpet. Nelson had trouble with it, but apparently Colorado has it at their own 23.
Well, that certainly could have been costly. Washington coming into the game, as we mentioned, fellas, aware of the CU kickoff return team, and they got the ball so high that Buffalo's had a tough time coming up and getting under it.
Darian Hagan, the talented quarterback. Kissy, the fullback. Kissick, the fullback. Pritchard and Eric Bieniemy, the running backs. Campbell, the wide receiver. Parrick, the tight end. Coleman, Garten, Lewenberg, Muhlenberg, and Vanderpool, the big and experienced offensive line. Hagan brings them out first and 10 from the 23. The handoff is a fake. Hagan's got it, and he's thrown for a loss. Number 56, Martin Harrison, third leading tackler so far in the season, throws Hagan for a 5-yard loss. Dennis Brown leads this up front defense for the Huskies with John Cook, Travis Richardson, Martin Harrison, the man who made that play. Chico Fraley, a high school teammate of Bieniemy's, Clifford and Travis. The secondary is led by number 6, Lilo Lang. He's there with Mincy, Briscoe, and Eugene Burkhalter, who was all over the field last Saturday night down in Arizona. They'll call it a loss of 3. It's second and 13. Hagan's got it. Out to about the 24. Travis Richardson, the right defensive end, 6'4", 245-pound junior, made the tackle.
First play, you see CU shift their tight end as Darian Hagan audibled at the line of scrimmage. The Buffaloes want to run away from number 79, Dennis Brown, who, as you mentioned, run an Outland Trophy candidate, 6'4", and 305 pounds. They've got to be able to adjust at the line of scrimmage, and he's got to be able to move people under very, very noisy circumstances. You can see him audibilizing right there.
It's third and 9. That is Pritchard in motion. Campbell is wide to the right. Hagan's pass is deflected, and it is intercepted. Number 28, Eric Briscoe, has given Washington the ball on the Colorado 33.
Well, a big emotional boost for the Huskies. It's the tip ball, a great play to intercept that.
This Husky team is characterized by being a little small, a little short on experience, but they sure came out fired up on defense, got good penetration, and now have the ball at the CU 32-yard line. And we'll see how the CU defense responds going up against Kerry Conklin and the Husky attack.
You can see Gary Barnett talking to Darian Hagan. Hagan didn't get back far enough. He dropped two steps back. The penetration got to him, and thus the turnover.
Conklin the quarterback. Compton is 36. Lewis is 20. That is Lewis in motion. Conklin to throw on first down. He's got time. And it's intercepted. Picked off by Tim James, the free safety. And Colorado has the football back at the 8-yard line.
Big mistake by Conklin because he had Lewis open. Lewis came out of the backfield. That's one of the few times you'll really see Washington come out in the eye. And you see, after going in motion, Lewis just drifts out off the left side of the line. He's going down the field, and Conklin has him here, just overthrows the ball. It was a bad throw, and nice pickoff there by Tim James, and a big turnover for the CU defense, just what they needed at the time.
Hey, really a bad decision by Conklin. Throws a little bit high, but receiver, when you're trying to dump that ball over somebody and in front of a rushing secondary, pretty tough throw.
Fellows, both teams look a little tight. First and 10, the ball is on the 9. J.J. Flannigan in the game. Here's J.J. He's hit by Harrison. Knocked down at the line of scrimmage. Two tackles now for Harrison. No gain.
They call Harrison a linebacker, but you'll see him mostly as a defensive lineman today. He's a pretty slippery guy. He's tough to block. He's not that big for a defensive lineman. As a linebacker, he's 6'5", 237, but he's not that... He's not that kind of guy who just presses upfield. He's slides off blocks, gets into gaps, makes things happen. Nice play there.
Less than 13 minutes to go in the first quarter already. Each team has turned it over. Hagan got a hold. Breaking tackles, and he's hit and down. Gang tackled at the 14. John Cook, number 93, the nose guard. One of the early arrivals. It's a pickup of 4. It'll be 3rd and a long 4.
You knew the Washington defense would come out and be very, very fired up. They were chastised by their head coach, Don James, after their play last week in Tucson. Good penetration by Purple Shirts. Hagan does a nice job of breaking tackles. They gave up 250 yards rushing last Saturday night in Tucson. And Don James said, we cannot win football games giving up that much yardage on the ground.
There's a good look at Hagan, what he's done on the ground. It is 3rd and a long 4. Looking, and he's sacked back at the 4-yard line. Number 39, Chico Fraley. And Colorado will have to punt from their end zone.
Well, Dennis Brown was probably the most physically intimidating player out on the field. Chico Fraley is the guy they think is their big play man. And Hagan here goes a little play action, tries the pump fake here, but Fraley has none of it. Takes him down inside the 5-yard line, and the Buffs will have to punt.
I'll tell you, Todd, that's a good job by Hagan, not throwing the football, not forcing a throw deep in your own territory. At least you give your club a chance to line up and punt the ball.
Tom Ruin is on 2nd in the nation in punting, averaging over 48 yards a punt. He'll need a big one here. Charles Mincy will let it bounce, and it goes into Husky territory before it is downed at the 44. An excellent punt of some 55 yards. 11-10 to go in the first quarter. We're scoreless here in Seattle.
Shure's new outdoor fresh scent is like a breath of fresh air.
Raise your hand.
You feel fresh now.
Raise your hand.
You feel clean now. You feel confident, secure.
Now get odor and wetness protection you can count on in a new fresh scent you'll love.
Raise your hand.
Fresh and new now.
Raise your hand.
You'll feel cool now.
Try new Shure outdoor fresh scent, as clean and fresh as all outdoors.
Raise your hand.
Raise your hand if you're sure.
Owning a home or a brand new car can be a dream come true. And USFNG can help to protect and cover you.
From the mountain's edge to the ocean's edge, we insure you every day. We protect what America's made of. We cover the USA.
It's a good look at Kerry Conklin, who's coming off a fine night last week, even in a losing effort. 27 of 43, 354 yards, a touchdown, and two interceptions. Those yards through the air are a career best for Conklin. First and 10. The ball at the Husky 44. Conklin. It's complete to the 48. Mark Jones is wrapped up there by Bruce Young. Mark Jones, a freshman out of Portland. 4-yard pickup, ball out to the 48, second and 6.
That's the kind of play with three wide receivers and a running back to the one side. When you send that running back in motion, nobody behind Conklin, you're going to pick up some yardage. See you that time rushing three players, you drop eight, you hope that nobody gets behind you, you come up and make the tackle. Washington will move the football today because they've got the kind of offense that simply dictates to you defensively what you can do, and that is predominantly play zone.
Kay and Riley are wide to the top of your screen on second and 6. Here's Lewis. Gets through the middle into Buff territory at the 46. Arthur Walker making the stop. Offensively for Washington, Conklin, the veteran quarterback. Lewis and Compton, the running backs. McKay, Riley, Bill Ames is a tight end. Up front, as Washington has a first down, Cooney, Schulberg, Brostek, Kahulukoa, and Sapele Malamala. It's a first down for Washington at the Buff 46. Minutes to go in a quarter. We're scoreless in case you joined us late. Lewis, the lone setback. The handoff to Lewis. Inside the 40. Down to the 35 where Bruce Young, along with Tim James, make the stop.
For a team that passes so much, they really run the football very well with Lewis. He's eighth in the nation right now in rushing.
Lewis, you're right, Tom, has really blossomed here in his junior year. 71 carries, 364 yards, averaging more than 5 a carry. Walker, Steve, Salavia, Alfred Williams, Terry Johnson, Michael Jones, and Canandis McGee, the front 7. McLuhan and Gibbs, the corners. Young and James, the veteran safeties. Conklin's got plenty of time. Dumps it off to his tight end, Ames. He's inside the 30 to the 29 where Michael Jones makes the stop, a pickup of 5, second and 5. Washington, fellows, has turned out some great quarterbacks. The Conklin's going to pass many of them, but Tom Flick, Chris Chandler, Sonny Sixkiller, Warren Moon, Don Heinrich, just to name a few.
Don Heinrich.
Back in your era, Davis.
Writing those pro football magazines now.
That's right. Second and 5, the ball on the 29. This is Lewis. He's got a first down. He's to the 23-yard line. Jones and Johnson combined to make the stop. Another Husky first down.
It's a dangerous offense, the one-back set, because when you flank so many receivers that you can get the ball to quickly, you've got to flank a defense, too. You can see good man-on-man blocking. As Tom said, Washington's been able to run the ball effectively in their game so far this year. But when you have to move linebackers out to cover wide receivers and simply take them out of the interior of your defense, much easier to run the football.
First and 10, the ball to 22. Pick to Lewis, he's got Conklin in front of, but Michael Jones snuffs it out.
That's not really their game plan. They really like to spread the field, like Dave was saying, and Lewis is simply perfect in this kind of offense because he's so slippery when the pass rush is coming, when they know you're going to throw. He's got great hands coming out of the backfield when they send him out, and he's just a nifty running back, but right there, Michael Jones all over him.
Good look there at Bill McCartney,
who said one of the keys today was his club's ability to tackle. If CU tackles well, they'll stay in this game. If you see the white shirts on the ground missing tackles, could be a long afternoon.
Second and 11. Conklin over the middle. Complete to the tight end, Ames. He loses the football and gets it back. Ames fumbled and recovered inside the CU 5, so a break for Washington. Michael Jones made the hit.
That's a brand new set for Washington. They started using it last week where they go to the two tight ends. They do keep a running back in the backfield. Ames still their primary target. You see he slides off, finds the dead spot there, makes the catch. He's hit and coughs up the football right there, but it comes right back to him inside the, right at the 5-yard line.
What a lucky bounce for Washington. Good job by the tight end Ames bouncing off of Terry Johnson. It's like a basketball pick. You just go in, find an area that you can get yourself open, look back, Conklin is right on you all the way. Pretty tough to stop.
They've got it marked in seven, which means they may have felt that he was down before the fumble. First and goal for Washington. Play action. Here comes the rush. Conklin will just throw it away. Tenavis McGee was all over Conklin, and Conklin got rid of it. He's having a few words now with Greg Lewis.
That's a smart play.
They've been very susceptible to weak side pressure for going away from the flow where the backside of the defense can chase him down.
Canavis, big play guy last year, coming off that broken ankle. Maybe not quite back to the caliber he was last year. Much bigger and stronger. Lost a little bit of his mobility, but that will come as he continues to get better this year.
We had a look at Don James, one of the successful coaches in all of college football. Second down and goal. Here is Lewis. Inside the five, down to the two, with Tim James stopped him there. It's third and goal. And very early on, fellas, this will be one of the big plays early in the ballgame.
Lewis hasn't had much of a chance to play in his first 2 years, but you can see his cutback ability. Good job of the offensive line of sealing that strong side and see you not getting off the blocks on the weak side to stop that cutback.
This drive started on the Washington 44. Third goal. Conklin's got it, down he goes. Joel Steve, the nose guard, the sophomore from Hinckley, made the big play. And the field goal team comes on for Don James. The CU defense did the job when they had to.
What a find Joel Steed has been for this team to come out of Hinckley and develop into the nose tackle that he is. He gets good penetration here, and Conklin has a little trouble with that exchange, but Steed's right there, and then the play is over. He's really developed, especially for a local guy to step in and do so well. It's big for the Buffaloes.
Washington runs the wishbone attack in short yardage. I think that's a tough offense to try to perfect if you don't run it all the time. You see that time, great penetration by CU.
Don McCallum, dead solid, perfect from 20 yards out, making him 7 of 8 on the season. So the senior from Seattle gives Washington the early lead. 5:57 to go in the first quarter. The Huskies are on the board.
Is brewed longer. One Dry is brewed from the most expensive ingredients. One Dry refreshes completely. One taste, and you'll know why. The One Dry is Michelob Dry. Although copiers are getting more and more sophisticated every day, their copies will never be as good as the original.
Washington 3, Colorado nothing. I guess somewhat of a moral victory for CU, keeping the Huskies out of the end zone as they had the ball down on the 2-yard line. CU is going to have to come up with something big on the offense. Washington is a gambling-style defense. I think most people are aware that once Don James sets his mind to stopping something, he's always had the ability to do so. I think you'll see CU pop something big. You'll see maybe reverse. You've got to get some emotion going in the offense. It's been all Washington so far, especially on the emotion side.
First off, what they need to do is get a better kick return. They really hurt themselves with field position on the opening kickoff when they barely recovered the football. David Gibbs had to come back and find the football for him, and they really should be making big plays in the kicking game against the Huskies.
McCallum to kick off. Washington out in front, a short kick. Gibbs crashes into Pritchard, misses Gibbs with a football. He's down shy of the 30.
See, that's a well-designed play. Washington's run it twice. You pop the ball in the air, you pop it down to the corner of the field, the court's telling your club as to which way you'll kick, and you take away that explosive return ability the CU has.
It's about a wedge, isn't it?
Yeah, a little nine iron straight up in the air.
He's got a ballata ball trying to back it up a little bit once he drops it there, but it's worked both times. It's really hurt the Buffs return teams, and now it's up to the offense to get something going.
First and 10 for Darian Hagan, the ball on the CU 27. George Hemingway in the game, number 22. This is Hemingway with a football. Runs hard across the 30, out to about the 33.
The thing to watch when you see Washington line up is where number 79 goes. Dennis Brown at 6'4 and 300 pounds is a legitimate Outland Trophy candidate, and they put him all over the line of scrimmage, usually working from the outside, sometimes towards the inside, even over the nose in certain situations. And he is a tremendous player, getting upfield and creating penetration. From there, you have to maybe get around it, but he is a sensational player to watch.
Well, he's a man.
Very quick for his size, too.
J.J. Flannigan out to about the 35. Dennis Brown again with help from Clifford.
Washington last year was dead last in the Pac-10 in giving up rushing yards. They averaged 201 yards against for the year. That was one thing that Don James, of course, we mentioned what he said last week, but after last year, a year they went 6-5, he said, hey, we are not going to make it unless we stop the run, do a much better job. They've concentrated on that. And so far in the first three contests, they've been pretty decent.
Third and two. That's Hemingway. He's got a first down across the 40 to the 45. Briscoe finally threw him down along with Lilo Lang, but a first down for the Buffs.
Darren Muhlenberg getting some daylight for the back to run through here.
So you can see how aware Washington is of the perimeter game. And they sneak Hemingway all the way to the free safety before anybody realizes that he has the football.
You really have to think the CU offensive line can move out the Washington offensive line and play smash ball with them effectively.
Good look at Hagan. First and 10 for Colorado. Bieniemy, number one, back in the ball game. Here's Eric. Trips and falls. Brown put him down for good at the 47. Brown is, you guys fellas have pointed out, so active, so tough to block. You don't know where he's going to line up. As Bieniemy gets up, claps his hands, says, come on, fellas. Grind it out.
The CU coaches told me that Dennis Brown does not read. He just steps upfield, creates havoc. If he's where the play is, he's going to end it quickly. If he's not where it is, he has such great pursuit skills, he goes right down the line of scrimmage and gets involved.
Second down and seven for Colorado. 3:35 to go in the first quarter. A mix-up. Hemingway's got it. Hemingway's got good yards. Finally, hog-tied by Eugene Burkhalter and brought down like he's a calf, but Hemingway running effectively very early here.
Well, I tell you, Hemingway ought to charge Burkhalter for the ride because he took him about 9 yards. It looked like Hemingway wanted the ball. Hagan wanted to take it back, and Hemingway say, uh-uh, I'm taking this one. And away we go. And again, Eugene Burkhalter is one of the better tacklers. Good luck when you have a 235-pound fullback coming up the middle, no matter how good you are tackling when you're a free safety.
15 yards for Hemingway as the Buffs are on the move. Big hole for Bieniemy. Eric breaks a tackle on a race to the corner. Touchdown.
What a job by the left side of the Buffs offensive line as they blew it open. Big daylight for Bieniemy. It became a foot race. He's not going to lose many of those. Look at the daylight here.
You're right. We've said so many times. Excellent block by Lewenberg. Look at the backside seal by Coleman. And watch Bieniemy pick up those feet. And once he senses the goal line, even at 5'9", he's very, very difficult to knock off his feet. He's got terrific balance and just enough speed to make it across the end zone line.
Well, you saw that tight shot of Bieniemy after that first run of this drive, and you could see the determination on his face. The next time he got it, 35 yards and a touchdown. Culbertson kicks it through. Colorado has the lead for the first time today with 3:07 left in this first quarter.
Most women need extra calcium. Tums EX means extra calcium. Tums EX is calcium carbonate, the kind of extra calcium doctors recommend. Tums EX antacid. It's part of taking extra good care of yourself.
Fancy perfumey aftershave. It's got to be a quarterback's locker.
Real guys who get mud on their uniforms use rugged, honest stuff. Ice Blue Aqua Velva.
There's something about today's Aqua Velva, man.
So you still think linemen are dumb?
Xerox presents the Great American Torture Test. We challenge the bone-numbing cold of northern Alaska and intense city traffic. Traveled coast to coast to the suffocating heat of Death Valley. And passed with flying colors. Xerox, because extreme conditions demand extreme protection.
When you block somebody that's 300 pounds, especially important, you gain great leverage. Look at the job Darren Muhlenberg does on Dennis Brown.
And George Hemingway finished the block. The enemy does the rest, pulling out of Eugene Burkhalter's tackle. Race to the end zone. Charles Mincy, the corner, tries to get over. Gets to him at the goal line, but the enemy finishes it off. That's his seventh touchdown of the year, and the Buffs have the lead, 7-3.
Six plays, 73 yards. Colorado settling themselves down. Both of you made the point that Colorado didn't have a lot of emotion the first couple of times. It looks like they're jacked up again. They seemed a little edgy, actually, at the beginning. And now it's up to their defense to use the field position they're going to gain here. Two freshmen back to return for the Huskies. Dino Bryant and Eric Alozio back to take the kick. This one is down by Alozi in the end zone. So Washington will take over first and 10 from the 20 behind for the first time this afternoon.
It's going to be interesting to see from operating from their own 20 how the Huskies attack the CU defense. As I said, they like to use the short, quick patterns, the three-step drop, and it kind of takes the pass rush out of the game. I was talking to some of the players from CU, and they were saying their job on the defensive line might not be so much to get sacks as to get in and get their hands up quick because Conklin gets rid of the football, but they come out in the eye.
Compton back in the game, first and 10, the ball on the 20. Lewis in motion. Completes it to Riley. McLuhan runs him out at the 28. An 8-yard pickup, second and 2. Riley, their leading receiver, 14 catches for 283 yards.
He's got very good speed. Since 1975, Washington has basically been an I-formation team. Keith Gilbertson arrived from the University of Idaho as their head coach, and he brought with him this particular style of offense, the two and three wide receivers, a lot of throwing, the one back set, spread the defense all over the field, and so far it's been quite effective.
Riley and McKay now in the bottom of your screen is a big hole for Compton. He's all the way out to the 41-yard line.
Compton's one of the reasons they run the eye. He's such a tough runner up the middle. He's a great blocker for Lewis. He weighs about 230 pounds, so you're not going to arm tackle this guy, but he had no problem here with big daylight up the middle, and if he hadn't tripped, might have had a bigger gain. Tim James was probably saying, oh, please go down.
You're not going to arm tackle him, but in this case, he tackles himself. Sometimes those big guys have trouble getting their feet out of the way once they get going. You see in the end zone, you're so happy that you've had a chance to get there, and your feet don't work quite as fast as your mind does.
On first and 10 from the 40, Conklin over the middle, nearly intercepted by Terry Johnson.
His receiver fell down. Greg Lewis was trying to set up in the middle and fell down. And one of the things that makes Conklin so effective in this kind of offense is that he uses everybody. He will spread the ball around to every eligible receiver on the field, and the defense cannot focus on one receiver or back coming out of the backfield because everyone's very eligible when they go out on a pattern with Conklin back there.
Conklin, 64 of 107 for 792 yards, five touchdown passes, and two interceptions, averaging 264 yards a game through the air. Conklin nearly falls down in the backdrop, throws and completes it to Ames. Out to the Washington 47, Williams and Johnson on the tackle. It'll be third and 3.
Well, that was a nice catch in traffic as he got sandwiched there. He's considered one of the harder workers on the Husky team. Bill Ames had major knee problems, needed major knee surgery last year. They didn't think he'd get back because he hurt his knee in the spring. Actually came back the fifth week of the season. So he's a guy who puts his effort into the game. Third down. And a couple. Conklin takes it up the middle, and it's going to be very close. Dave, you have the best set of eyes. You make the first call of the day.
I will initially say from that angle that he's going to be a little bit short.
I'd say he's a foot shy where they have him marked right now.
Well, you've got the glasses, I mean.
Yeah, well, I'll cheat.
I must attest, Dave looking with the naked eye, making the call, and I believe he's correct.
I don't know that there's a decision at midfield this early in the game. Don James is one that usually plays the percentages. Might not like it here in the stands, but Washington is going to have to punt the football.
You guys didn't get the complimentary Channel 9 binoculars?
I didn't even get one of those little nine pins, did you?
Hey, we were lucky to make the flight. What, are you kidding me?
They're going to measure here.
There's the measurement. Dave Logan corrected, a foot short. Big crowd here. They're thinking it's in the neighborhood of 70 to 72,000. The boats off the shore in Lake Washington. Beautiful setting for football.
The Washington players signaling we're going to go for it. I guess they've talked Don James into it.
And they must have, because you can see the punt team led by Channing Wiles trots off. The crowd is jacked up as the offense trots on, fourth and a foot.
This is dangerous for the passing team because you think they're going to send Compton up the middle, but they really could burn you if they decide to stroke the ball.
I'll tell you what, though, if you're a defensive coordinator, Mike Hankwitz, I think you have to play the run. If they throw the football, we will be the most surprised people in Husky Stadium.
The bone. Full house. Conklin falls down, gives it to Compton, and I think he is short. We'll wait and unstack, but I don't believe he got enough.
This is going to be close. They're marking him across the 50. That's a first down.
That's a first down. They may have got a very favorable spot because Conklin fell down as he made the handoff.
Almost a disaster for the Huskies, but they will maintain possession. See the crowd here. We saw some people kayaking to the game a little earlier out on the water.
Watch Conklin here, fellas.
Looks like he got his left foot stepped on by the right guard.
Compton barely got the exchange.
I'm going to tell you, if he got to the 50. Well, it's over now. First and 10. Compton a hole inside the 45, down to the 43. The strong safety, Bruce Young, made the tackle a pickup of 7. Second and 3.
One thing that makes this offense so very, very tough, if they can establish a running game, it's going to be very, very difficult for the CU defense to play as well pass defense as they need to. You can't, as a defense, you have to take something away. At least you try to. You either want to stop the run or you want to stop the pass. But so far, Washington's had pretty good success with both.
Good point. Second down and short. Passing chance if Conklin wants to take it. Complete to McKay. Catch. McKay is down to the 35 where Young made the tackle. Another Washington first down. Orlando McKay, 5'11", 180-pound sophomore.
Don James has to be happy with the way they're moving the football, but they're also doing something else. They're keeping the Buffalo offense off the field. Time is running out here in the first period, and CU's only had the football twice, really. They fumbled it away one time. They had to kick, and then they got the touchdown drive. CU's yet to throw for any yards. Washington's moving it ball.
Excuse me, Tom. The biggest chore for the CU defense and the coaches this week was to make sure the team didn't get down, because this was going to be a challenge for them, and Washington has the ability to move the ball. They'll move it in chunks. The key will be what the Huskies do with the football once they get it down in the scoring territory. It becomes a little bit more difficult for a passing team to get in the end zone.
Compton took it down to the 33 where Jones made the stop. That will presumably be the final play of the first quarter. Pickup of 3, and it's been a very entertaining first quarter with Colorado out in front. We played a quarter here in Seattle. The Buffs 7, the Huskies 3. We'll be back in just a minute.
The shape is distinctively advanced. Cockpit designed for comfortable travel over time and distance. The Honda Prelude SI, a slightly ahead of its time machine. shape our future, we invite you to learn the technology of tomorrow while you serve your country in the Navy of today.
Now that's a sight right there. That's a couple of football throws away from where we're standing.
John Elway throws.
On an overcast day, it's still beautiful here. This is quite a setting. This stadium is probably in as beautiful a spot as you could imagine.
After a quarter, you can see Colorado out in front on the ground and Washington dominating through the air, but the only stat that counts is Colorado 7, Washington 3.
Real balance, though, for Washington in the way they're moving the football, and that's what's creating so many problems for Mike Hankwitz and the CU defense.
Washington has it as we start the second quarter, 2nd and 7 from the Colorado 32. This drive started on the Husky 20. Compton and Lewis behind Conklin. He'll dump it out to Lewis. Gets by Johnson. He's got a block inside the 20 where Alfred Williams makes the tackle at the 19. A 13-yard gain and another Washington first down.
A very safe throw, and you'll see the dump to Lewis. Colorado with a four-man rush actually has a chance to make the play, but Terry Johnson right there gets blocked, and a good block by number 51, Dean Kirkland. CU wants the clip, no clip called, and again, very, very safe on the throw. You just dump it out to your running back, you let him make people miss, and you pick up positive yards.
Lewis, an all-purpose threat, his 12th catch of this young season. Play action. Conklin his own pass. Williams deflected it. Conklin got it back and it was nailed. I think we learned not to catch that ball, bat that thing down.
I was going to say, I think Washington's more dangerous from here as far as getting into the end zone than they are up close. And this is a funny play.
I tell you, Kerry Conklin will tell Don James in the meetings tomorrow, hey, I signed on as a quarterback. You can forget this receiving bit. Oof. Canavis McGee gets a free shot at a quarterback turned receiver.
Speaking of a quarterback we all know well, number 7 in Denver, he's learned to knock those down when they come his way.
Or get knocked down.
That's right. 2nd and 14. Lewis in motion. Conklin throws incomplete. Canavis McGee was all over Bill Ames, but there is no flag.
CU only elected to rush 3 there, and Canavis with some good coverage if you include grabbing and holding.
he may have a little purple paint on his left hand. We'll see if we can see it. Bottom left-hand corner, Conklin decides to go to Ames. Now watch where Canavis McGee's left hand is. Right in the middle of the left shoulder pad of Ames, the tight end.
Now here on 3rd and long, I'd like to see CU do something a little more aggressive than send 3 guys. I'd like to see him put a little pressure on Conklin. He does make good decisions, but they line up in a 4-down front.
Rally and McKay wide to the left, the bottom of your screen. Conklin. He was looking for Riley, but Young and McLuhan were there, and it's 4th down, and the field goal team will come on for Washington. And this will be a rather long attempt, about 40 yards.
Alfred Williams gets my nod for the coverage there. He got great pressure in on Conklin. And I think if you can get pressure on him, if you put him in a 3rd and 14 where he can't take a 3-step drop, he's got to drop 7-8 yards like Illinois' Jeff George had to a couple of weeks ago, you're going to get a chance to put some pressure on him, and you got to take that chance.
Well, the key is they got pressure on him with 4 men. Didn't have to bring a linebacker, take a backer out of the coverage scheme. Very good pass rush that time by CU.
McCallum, already good on his first attempt of the day. And he's good on his second from 40 yards out. McCallum, now 8 of 9 on the season. 13:30 to go in this first half. Colorado out in front, 7-6.
My brother Tom used to flip me out. Every time I'd be watching a TV show I liked, he'd start flipping through the channels. Then we got this amazing Magnavox TV with a built-in smart window.
Smart window.
That lets Tommy flip through all the channels while I keep watching what I want to watch.
Now I can see what I've been missing.
And that's quite a lot.
Yeah, thank you.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
just off Route 19 in St. Petersburg, is a place where you can learn to ski the Alps and shoot the rapids all in the same building. At Bill Jackson Sporting Goods, you can practice everything from a Stim Christie to an Eskimo roll. But if you go there, remember, bring your imagination and your Visa card. Because Bill Jackson doesn't promise you Sun Moritz, and he doesn't take American Express. Visa, it's everywhere you want to be.
When you've got your power stroke going, you've got confidence that nothing's going to beat you. Introducing Power Stick, the new antiperspirant that gives you 24-hour odor and wetness protection in just one wide stroke. It takes two strokes of the leading stick to match Power Stick's one-stroke protection, 24-hour protection. In just one stroke, new Power Stick from Fabergé.
The Shillings were burned out of their home. They called me. I'm their State Farm agent, Bill Clulow. Right away, I teamed up with a State Farm claims representative. I gave him all the information he needed, and Tom got to work fast.
I didn't get there as quick as the fire trucks did, but I made sure the Shillings had a place to stay, money to live on, and got their claims started fast.
Now the Shillings know a big reason why State Farm insures more homes than anyone else.
State Farm teamwork helps you get back in your home fast.
State Farm is there.
9 KUSA, making a difference.
The beauty that is the great Northwest. We've joined our stay here in Seattle as Colorado out in front 7-6 after McCallum's second field goal of the day. This one from 40 yards cuts the deficit to 1 point for Washington.
And although Washington has had some success moving the ball, again, they've had it in scoring position and have come away with two field goals. I'm sure Don James is a bit upset with the happenings here in the first half. You have to take advantage. Once you get down there, boy, you got to knock it in. And that says a lot so far for the CU defense.
Mike Pritchard and MJ Nelson are creeping up almost to the 10-yard line this time, looking for the return. Those two punch kicks have worked very well for Washington's coverage teams.
That's a good point, Tom. The kicks have been short and have kept it away from Nelson. We'll see what they do on their third kick of the afternoon. This one a little deeper. Pritchard from his nine. Comes to the side. Across the 25 to the 27. Our first flags of the day are down back at the 19, and this one will be on Colorado.
I was just going to say, we haven't had any penalties yet.
Despite the field position that they're going to end up with, it's got to be a moral victory that the return men actually caught the football. After a couple of plays by David Gibbs on the kick return, they finally got one of the guys they wanted with the football, but the penalty, the clip, is going to move it back probably inside the 10-yard line.
Referee today is James Folkants. The umpire is Walt Wolf.
Let's take a look at it. See if we can see the clip. And there, I believe, right in the middle of your screen, tough to see the number. Might have been two clips. Actually, there were three flags in the play. They may have got two or three clips.
First down.
Buffs will have to bring it out of their own end now as they get the ball at the nine.
O.C. Oliver, the bottom of your screen in the ball game for the first time, number five.
Pac-10 coaches said Husky Stadium, the noisiest place to play on the road in the Pac-10. And at home, you're probably getting a pretty good dose of it.
And you're right, Dave. It is loud. As loud as it's been all afternoon as Flannigan busts across the 15 to the 17. An 8-yard pickup. Chico Fraley, number 39, made the stop.
After a slow start, you really have to look for CU to start running straight ahead. They've had some room up the middle. That big offensive line is starting to peel some holes open against the slightly undersized Washington front three. They really put Martin Harrison down at a defensive end. They also have three sophomores starting at linebacker. So there's some inexperience there, and you have a chance to maybe make a gap and make a big play.
I'm going to tell you something else. Both inside linebackers for the Huskies, very, very small, 205 and 228.
Second down and two, up the middle. It's Kissick. He's got a first down across the 20 out to the 24, where Charles Mincy, along with Burkhalter, finally made the stop, a CU first down. That takes the crowd out of it a little bit.
See, if you're the Washington defense here, boy, you've got them right where you want them. You want to force CU to stay down in their end, to punt the football. Your offense has had pretty good success. They've allowed one first down, but paramount now for the Husky defense to play tough against the run and stop CU from monopolizing the time of the clock.
And I would think CU is getting more and more confident. difference. They can run the football against this defense. Hagan, the pitch to Flannigan, loses it. I believe J.J. covered it. He did at the 24. A loss of one. Harrison made the stop.
See, Flannigan and Hagan talking about the first time they've had the chance to actually pitch the ball today.
The pitch was high. It got up on J.J.'s shoulder. It was a tough pitch to handle. And luckily, they were able to come away with the football. But you can see Hagan here pitches the ball a little quicker than he has to as Harrison comes up on him. And the pitch is high up on the shoulder. And Flannigan more or less just keeps it in front of him and recovers it. And the Buffs maintain possession.
A little behind him, too.
Flannigan and Kissick still in the game behind Hagan. Arian, it's the throw. Now he'll run. Dennis Kraft, number 79, smacked up Hagan at the 27. Let's go down to the sidelines and Mark McIntosh.
Thank you very much, Ron. It has started to miss very lightly down here. And I just talked to equipment manager Bill Crowder, and he said 20 hours before the game, they sprayed a dry ball material on the footballs just in case this miss would start to fall so the CU quarterbacks get better grip on that football.
Thanks very much, Mark. Mark McIntosh working the game with us today on the sidelines as he does throughout the year on our CU telecast. Third down and eight. The ball is on the 27 and Colorado stops and takes a timeout. 11:06 to go in the half. We'll be back to Seattle in just a minute.
On this job, it doesn't take long to get a pounding headache. Even when the noise stops, I can still feel it drilling away up here. For headaches, I used to take aspirin or Tylenol, but today I take Advil. See, Advil's strong. Just one Advil is as effective as two regular strength Tylenol. And Advil doesn't upset my stomach the way aspirin can. Advil gets rid of my tough headache so I can give everything to the job. Advil, tablets and caplets, advanced medicine for pain.
Observed that few things can compete for one's loyalty and affection more than a Honda.
Another gorgeous afternoon in Seattle as you see traffic just outside the stadium. This is a great area, great city. Third and eight, ball is on the 27. Richard and Campbell ride to the top of your screen. Hagan hands it off to Flannigan. He's going to be short. He's across the 30 to the 32. James Clifford, the leading tackler on this team, sophomore from Seattle, made the stop, and CU will have to punt.
We said earlier that Washington, coming into this afternoon's game, very much aware of CU's rushing ability. They're going to make him throw the ball. That time, almost a delay to Flannigan. Since CU really hasn't had much of a chance to throw the ball, with Washington having seven guys in the line of scrimmage, that play not going to be very effective.
Real conservative call, I think. Bill McCartney might have been happy just to move that ball when they had it on their own nine to get it out past the 30 and let Tom Ruin kick it away.
Charles Mincy is deep for the Huskies. Ruin is inside his 20. 7-6 Colorado, 10:50 to go in the first half. Ruin picks it up, gets it off. Takes a Washington bounce back towards the 40, and it's down at the 38. 10:42 to go in the first half. Colorado out in front, 7-6.
The shape is distinctively advanced. Cockpit designed for comfortable travel over time and distance. The Honda Prelude SI, a slightly ahead of its time machine.
My athlete's foot kept flaring up. Put it out, it just flare up again. Then my doctor told me about Tenactin. It cures recovering athlete's foot. Use it regularly, It'll keep the fire from coming back.
Dinactin puts the fire out for good.
The lights on these cars are running on battery power alone. And in the end, only one, the car with a new die-hard battery, our most powerful ever, is able to start. Great low prices every day, die-hard power. That's your money's worth and a whole lot more.
We'd like to pass along a nice note from Boulder today. The men's and women's basketball teams from CU raised $2,100 this morning for the Sal Aunese Fund. Members of both teams washed cars in Boulder, and at $3 apiece, over 600 cars turned out. CU Athletic Department wants to thank everyone for coming out and the basketball teams for doing their part.
Well, that's terrific. That is. On first and 10, Conklin looks for Ames, and he couldn't hang on. Terry Johnson was there on the coverage. In case you missed the beginning, Dave, certainly an emotional moment for fans is a moment of silence here for Sal Aunese.
Yeah, it was a nice tribute, certainly, to Sal. You can see early Washington trying to get the football into the hands of the tight end. CU aware of the wide receivers, and they, for the most part, have locked up those linebackers on the tight end. I think offensively, when you can get that match, especially with a good athlete like Ames, you want to take full advantage of it.
Conklin, 7 of 11 so far for 60 yards with that incompletion.
Conklin over the middle again. This one complete to Mark Jones. Flag is down.
Conklin had his biggest game in his career last week against Arizona, 27 of 43 for 354 yards, but the Huskies lost 20 to 17.
That not only was Conklin's biggest game, that was Don James' biggest game as head coach here at Washington, 354 yards worth. They've got holding on CU defensively. Mark Jones, if that's a familiar name, initially had signed with the University of Colorado. Got himself into some problems out in the San Diego area. Bill McCartney decided that he was not the type kid that he wanted with his program, and he turned around and went to Washington.
Of course, talking about that, Darian Hagan was highly recruited by both of these universities.
Holding on the defense during a legal forward pass. It's an automatic first down.
Back, Hagan said it came down to CU and Washington, and Washington wanted him as a running back, CU wanted him as a quarterback.
He said he appreciated Don James being honest with him and telling him he was going to be a running back and not telling him he was going to be a quarterback just to get him into the school.
First and 10 for the Huskies, the ball just on the Washington side of the 50. A handoff to Lewis. He bounces around the corner into CU territory, down to the 41. Young, James, and Williams all there to make the stop. That'll be close to a Washington first down.
The one back offense again, and you'll see Lewis with the ability to bounce it outside. Now, Bruce Young is the guy that has to make the tackle, and you can see he gets blocked.
Nice job by the tight end, Bill Ames, also picking up and stopping Alfred Williams, preventing the contain. You know, a lot of people talk about Don James and how long he's been coaching here. I'm not sure a lot of people back home remember that he was an assistant at CU back in 1968, 69, and 70. That goes way back. I mean, that's way back in like when Dave Logan was around.
He was a pretty good coach, too. Got his first head job at Kent State University. Also spent some time at the University of Michigan as defensive coordinator.
You and Bill McCartney have something in common there.
18 years as a head coach, 12. This is his 13th season in Washington. One of the deans of the business right now.
Well, he's the winningest coach in Washington history. He's had 12 straight winning seasons. Remarkable record.
Considered an excellent game plan coach. Week to week, he is as prepared for an opponent as any coach in the nation.
There was a time, Dave and Tom, that he wanted the CU job. Or was at least interested.
Very much so.
We're inside of 10 minutes to go in the half. Second and inches. Compton. 35. Young and Salavea on the tackle. Of course, Oakland playing with a heavy heart. Sal Aunese's best friend, almost like a member of the Aunese family. And he'll be going directly to San Diego for the funeral on Monday, as will Bill McCartney and a number of other CU officials.
Some people are only born to do one thing. James Compton was born to be a fullback. 5'11", 235 pounds, finishes his runs, executes his job, likes contact. He's a real asset to them when they do go to the eye.
Washington grinding out first downs, but they only have two field goals to show for it. Lewis. And the ball is loose. Colorado thinks they have it.
I think he's going to be ruled down.
And the ball is ruled down. Michael Jones came up with it, so all it is a three-yard gain.
You can see CU very, very aggressively going after the football. That's fine, and you're going to get your share of turnovers that way, but you also are going to miss some tackles unless you're aware of wrapping the guy up and then going for the football. First guy that gets to the ball carrier has to try to make the tackle, and then numbers two, three, and four, and from that point on can go for that football.
At the 24, Jones makes sure he's down. That should be enough for another Washington first down. Another good decision by Conklin, as he had all sorts of daylight off to his front and left when he pulled the football down, and see with a three-man rush really not able to get a lot of pressure on him.
He's a good enough athlete. Wide. Good enough athlete that he can do it. Last year threw 12 interceptions, and Don James said if I could change one thing, I would change his ability to make the correct decision. And that time, Tom, you're absolutely right. Pulled it down and got a first down.
6'4", 215. Great size for a quarterback. First and 10. Inside the Colorado 25. Here's Lewis. Tries to get around the corner. Young trips him up, and Lewis is down at the 21. Steed was there as well, a three-yard gain.
I said earlier, Bruce Young having to make a tackle on that one-back counter tray move, and Young there in time to make it.
Nice move by Lewis to pull Alfred Williams in and let him get the corner.
This telecast is a cooperative presentation of KCNC-TV and KUSA-TV. It is intended for the private use of our audience. Any reproduction or rebroadcast of this telecast without the expressed written consent of KCNC and KUSA is prohibited. You did very well. And we'll never hear that one again, that's for sure. Conklin looking to throw, and it's incomplete.
I think that ball was tipped. And that's what they're talking about with those short, quick passes that you almost have to rush with your hands up in the air.
Fellas, the intended receiver was Jay Barry from Kent, Denver, who's in the ballgame.
See, Oakland Salavea, number 99. Let's see if he gets his left hand up and tips the football. Actually, both hands up and tips that ball away.
They've been working on that all week. They really think even though Conklin is 6'4", that because he throws the short pass, he throws the ball flat. He throws them in a range where they can get their hands on it and make big plays like that.
Barry, the son of Odell Barry State, former Bronco, stays in the game on third and seven. Conklin loses the snap, and Michael Jones wraps him up back at the 23.
You know, that's a play that the offensive coordinator in the booth takes his headset off. He's throwing it against the wall. Why can't we get the snap? And you can't tell if Conklin pulls out too quickly. Has a very, very good offensive center in front of him, Bert Brostick, who a lot of folks think might very well be a top draft choice next year in the NFL draft. But, boy, the thing that kills you is you cannot get that snap up.
And we've seen both times they've gone to third and long, CU's been able to get pressure on the quarterback and make big plays. All they got to do is get him in that situation.
Here's McCallum, who's 8 of 9 this season, 2 of 2 today. This attempt from 40 yards out. It is up, and it is no good.
I think that caught a piece of the upright on the right side, did it?
It was close. Hard to tell. Maybe we can get another look, Tom, but it may have grazed the right upright. We'll sort it out. 6:41 to go in the half. Colorado remains on top.
I know college won't be an easy climb. That's why I joined the Army. With the GI Bill and the Army College Fund, in 2 years I'll have $17,000 to help me pay for college. And I'm developing the confidence and determination I'll need to help me succeed when I get there. Now I know I can make it to the top. Not just in college, but in whatever I do.
John McCallum, the Husky kicker, certainly has enough leg and elevation. This looks like a five iron with a little draw. Watch the ball start to move in. It's coming in. He probably thinks, aha, and it actually nicks the upright.
Washington's chance to take the lead goes by the boards, and the Buffs take over at 23.
Ironically, his only other miss of the season came last week in Tucson, a 41-yarder that would have given the Huskies the lead.
On first and 10, Bieniemy back in the game. Nice twisting, turning move. He will not come down. He's finally brought down to 32. Eric Bieniemy shows you how to gain 9 yards on his own. This is a situation where if the Buffaloes can establish control of running up the middle of the field, establish the center of the line of scrimmage is where they want to run the football, then they can do what really looks like something that Washington's susceptible to, misdirection, reverses, passing the football. But it won't happen until they establish the middle of the field as their own on runs like that by Bieniemy.
And again, two inside linebackers, Chico Fraley and James Clifford, both undersized. Colorado doing a good job of running right at them.
Hemingway. He's got a first down and a flag is down. It's Hemingway across the 35.
These guys are undersized in the middle, and what that means is they're very active and very athletic, and they run to the football very well. They pursue the ball extremely well. The problem with that is then you start to misdirect the football. They over-pursue. Cutbacks and things like that are going to work for the Buffs today, and they're going to need a big play now after the 10-yard penalty.
Bill McCartney all the way out in the field, and I think he's most upset with the fact that the holding call came in very, very late. Hemingway already had the football 3 or 4 yards down the field. You'd never like to get a holding call, but you certainly don't like to get one after you've picked up the first down. See if we can see it. Hemingway inside. Muhlenberg, number 63. Tough to tell. But I'll tell you what, if it's on him.
And that came from the left side of the field on the right guard. I can't imagine that being the call, or if it was, how that referee saw it.
CU, fellas, penalized 3 times now for 33 yards. Washington has yet to be penalized. So, 10 yards on CU. The ball's back to the 22, where it is now 2nd and 12. MJ Nelson and Campbell in the game as wide receivers. Brown jumped over the line of scrimmage, and this one is whistled dead.
Boy, he's quick.
That he is.
A little bit too quick.
Too quick there.
Hey, when you're 305 pounds and you decide to go, there's no way in the world to stop.
He's really the anchor of this defense. He's the one guy with the size that allows them to control the line of scrimmage.
Dead ball,
off the front, they're just not
off
that big.
Sides. On the defense, 5 yards.
You know, it looks like the rain has picked up a little bit. I don't know what effect that may have on the two offenses, but some of these shots, it looks like it is raining.
You know, interestingly enough, Don James says that Dennis Brown hasn't even played up to his potential yet. NFL scouts say he's a surefire first-round pick.
2nd and 7 from the 27. Bieniemy across the 30 to the 32. Let's go down to the sidelines and Mark McIntosh.
You're right, Ron. The rain is coming down a little heavier, and the Buffs have switched shoes. They've gone from a flat-soled shoe to a shoe that has small little cleats on it to get better traction. Back upstairs.
Thanks, Mark. And there is a graphic description of what you were talking about as the Buffs have changed shoes.
They look like shoes Floyd Patterson would wear.
It's kind of hard to find that many styles of black shoes, but somehow they've done it at CU.
Maybe Jim Turner's old shoes. 3rd and 2. Hemingway. He's got a first down out to the 35. Hemingway having a big first half.
Darren Muhlenberg getting the job done there, just driving out of his right guard spot. You know, the Buffs have two guys on their offensive line who know what it takes to win. Bill Coleman and Darren Muhlenberg took part on 2 separate state championship football teams. Of course, Coleman playing at North Glen, they beat Cherry Creek, and Muhlenberg playing at Lakewood, and they beat Cherry Creek. So it's been a couple of guys who were part of programs that weren't supposed to do that well, and there's just something about them. They know what it takes to win.
4.5 minutes to go in the first half. 7-6. Bieniemy darts through the hole. He's across the 40 out to the 42. Burkhalter made the stop, the free safety.
CU has had so many big plays in the first 3 games. What you're seeing here this afternoon is the Buffaloes making a statement that we can knock you off the ball. We don't have to throw it. We don't even have to pitch it. We're simply going to run between the tackles and stop us if you can. That's fine as long as your offensive line controls the line of scrimmage. They've had their moments against a very good defensive output this year.
Campbell, the hook and ladder. It's got Pritchard down the sidelines, and he's down to the Washington 32. First down, Colorado.
As soon as I say they decided they're going to run the ball between the tackles, here we go with the trick play, if you will. This was a play they opened up the Oklahoma game with last year, if you can remember. The hook and ladder, and here comes Pritchard. And from that angle, it looks like Pritchard has a chance to score. Good job of the Washington defense. The main thing you want to do as a receiver, first catch the ball and then locate with your eyes Mike Pritchard. An excellent job by Jeff Campbell.
First and 10 from the 32 off the hook and ladder. Here's Bieniemy. Down to the 27.
One thing we're getting to see here today is a CU team that is so balanced as far as the talent positions that Darian Hagan still has not been a factor outside of that pass. He has not been the explosive runner that he's been the first three games so far, and he's still getting the job done.
Let's go down to Mark McIntosh.
About with the hook, as you were talking about the hook and ladder, Darian Hagan talking to him earlier this week, he said he had a few trick plays up his sleeve, and you just saw one back upstairs.
Here's the handoff to Pritchard. He's across the 25 to the 24. It'll be third and about a yard. John Cook, the nose guard, made the stop.
Like I was saying earlier, I think we're going to see more of those kind of plays, those misdirection plays, try and get the Washington defense that flows to the ball so well, make them pay for that and make them play the straight ahead run a little more honestly.
And that's a new wrinkle with Pritchard in motion, cutting back on the inside counter, something we haven't seen so far this year.
It's raining hard right now, as you can see there on the screen of the shot of Bill McCartney. Rain is coming down hard. Third and one for the Bucs. 2.5 minutes to go in the half. Hagan's got it. Inside the 20. Hagan will have a first down as he's collared out by Burkhalter at the 16.
Seems like the Husky defense have become awfully conscious of George Hemingway slamming up the middle, especially in short yardage situations. But they bit a little bit inside there and left the outside open, and Hagan only too quick for them.
But good job by Darian Hagan riding Hemingway into the line of scrimmage, pulling that ball out when the defensive end crashed, picking up the necessary yards for the first down. That's what you have to do as an option quarterback. You may have 15 carries one game, and the next game, if you're reading correctly, you may have 4 or 5. You can't be a selfish player and run the option the correct way.
First and 10 from the 16. Hagan's got it. He'll keep it inside the 5, and Hagan is knocked out on the 3. Lilo Lang made the tackle, but another Colorado first down, 13-yard pickup for Darian Hagan.
You know, one thing you can't teach in option football is speed. And this is what this play is all about. Hagan making the correct read, gets inside blocking by Hemingway, and now he is to that corner of the seam, and he's running as fast as he can go right there.
Nice convoy, too. Muhlenberg and Hemingway are out in front of him there. He's got 7 carries now for 30 yards.
This drive started inside the Colorado 10. The enemy is down near the goal line, but not in. What a boost for Colorado if they can get in here in the final couple of minutes.
They're going to have their hands full if they punch it in here with 2 minutes to go, and the Husky passing attack might open up a little bit, but first things first, second and goal at the 1.
Clock is running, minute 50 to go in the first half. You can see how close the ball is. Bloomberg over the football. The enemy up and over. Touchdown.
It's kind of hard to draw that one on the chalkboard because it's three-dimensional.
not for us. You just get him on a trampoline.
Look at the hang time here. The safety should have called for a fair catch trying to pick him up.
I tell you, he did that against CSU, and I thought he got 7 or 8 yards up in the air, came down on his head, was scary, and he bounced right back up.
You know, the only way to stop that play is to get great penetration by the defensive line and actually get to the enemy while he's just starting to launch himself in the air. If he gets into the air, all you can do is catch him once he comes down.
And Culbertson puts it through, and with a minute 41 to go, Colorado stretches the lead. The Buffs 14, the Huskies 6.
The on-off endurance test. The shake test. Impact test. You'll probably buy only one furnace in your life. So buy the one that's built to last a lifetime.
The Lennox Pulse Gas Furnace. Take it from Dave Lennox.
For home heating, for cooking, hot water, or drying, choose gas. America's best energy value.
Daddy, I want my Jenny beer.
I want my soda.
Grandma, isn't this fun?
Oh. I want my soda.
Why do people want a Serta? The answer is the exclusive Serta Surface. It tops firm support with layers of thick, luxurious comfort. It'll spoil you for sleeping any other way. So get a Serta Perfect Sleeper.
I want my Serta.
1:41 to go before the half. The Buffs now lead it 14-6. Let's take a look at it again. Now, this is a one-yard touchdown run in the book, but Eric Bieniemy goes about 5 yards airborne. He takes off between the 2 and the 3, and he definitely lands at least 2 yards deep in the end zone. He's about 4 yards in the air, it seems like.
Well, he almost literally jumps over Eric Kissick, and Kissick just bent over a little bit.
I don't think Eric had any clue how the play went. All of a sudden, he sees number one like Superman going over the top. And the Buffs lead at 14-6 with 1:41 to go.
I tell you, you got to have a big heart to put your body in that position. As Ron said, we saw him land on his head a couple of times and look to be seriously injured, but it does not persuade him from trying it again.
Fellas, this may be a very key minute 41. CU has the momentum. They have their biggest lead, and now they've got to make sure, from their point of view, that they shut down the Huskies in this final minute 40. Eno Bryant, 29. Eric Alozie, number 9 or deep. This is Bryant on the 7. Bryant's got a hole. Crossed the 30. Crossed the 40. He's finally run out by Tim James at the Washington 45-yard line. This is what I meant. Colorado's got to be careful not to allow Washington to establish anything here right at the end of the half.
Culbertson with a short kickoff really opened the door, and they got a nice wedge. Don James has been famous for his special teams, but this year they have yet to execute some big plays. It's either on coverage or on returns. Look at the replay. Takes it here at about the 7, carries it out 38 yards. He's a freshman, 5'11", 175, Beano Bryant, and he gets it all the way up to the 45-yard line before getting tripped up.
Riley is wide to the left. Jones and McKay wide to the right. Looking for McKay. James and Young were both there. Second and 10. Then a 28 to go and a half.
The clock hurts Washington here because they like that short ball control passing game, but really don't have quite enough time to use it, even though they're at the 45-yard line. There you saw Conklin on first down taking the normal drop about 7 yards, and this isn't exactly what they like to do.
I'll tell you this, though, with the short passing game and the timeouts left, they still have three timeouts. They've got plenty of time to utilize that to get down into position with a very good field goal kicker where they could get 3 points. And it would be big because of what's happened on that last drive by CU.
Conklin. And it's intercepted by Bruce Young. And Lewis may have saved a Colorado touchdown.
Well, I tell you, Bruce Young gets a running start on this throw and literally takes off before Conklin even throws the ball. Kerry Conklin locked on the receiver the entire way. You can see Andre Riley doesn't come back to the ball, and Bruce Young makes a great cut on the football. He took off from the strong safety position. I don't know if we can see it, but he undercuts this throw before Conklin even lets it go. You can see Young has already taken off, gets between Riley and the football. Just a great play by the strong safety.
Should Riley be moving back to the football?
Well, he's got to come back a little bit, but I think that time Kerry Conklin was the one that eyeballed that receiver. He let Bruce Young get a running start, and no way in the world to avoid that interception.
Hagan looking to throw with time. Pritchard's got it at the 8. Another big Colorado play as the Buffs have it first and goal. 12 to go in the half, and this game has just turned around in the last minute.
Mike Pritchard gets behind Charles Mincy here, and he's all alone, even though the throw's a little slow. Actually, he gets behind Briscoe. And the Buffs, all of a sudden, a big momentum shift, a pick by Bruce Young, the long pass play, minute 7 to go, and they're knocking at the door.
I'll tell you, Briscoe really a bit on the out and up move. Pritchard to the sideline, a nice pump by Hagan, and Pritchard gets behind him.
Cuts inside, and he's down to the 5, where he's hit there.
Well, what a turn of events, as it looked like Washington, with several scoring opportunities in the first half, might take control, and how quickly things can reverse in college football.
Colorado takes a timeout. Don't go away. When we come back, we'll see if Colorado can slam it in.
A6, hurry and you'll make it.
Delta Airlines ticket agent Sam Singletary knows how to get people moving.
Mr. Franklin, you're back.
But sometimes he has to show off a few moves of his own. The kind of moves that made him a first-string halfback. Sam Singletary shares a feeling with everyone at Delta. He loves what he's doing. And it shows.
We love to fly.
He's the kid.
And it shows.
I never understood some of these computer companies. You call in their service people and they give you an attitude. If I had even a couple of pieces of somebody else's equipment anywhere in my organization, they acted like I made a terrible mistake. The problem always seemed to be in the other guy's equipment. But that's all history now. I just signed a new agreement with IBM. They've taken full responsibility for servicing all my computer equipment, no matter whose name is on it.
Nice play action fake, and watch Darian Hagan as he waits for Pritchard to clear. There's the pump, and believe me, Washington bites on the out move. Pritchard able to duck up the seam right towards the sideline. And over the ball a little bit late. It's a pretty good throw by Darian Hagan as he pulls up, stays inside his blocking scheme, and delivers the football.
Pritchard gave him plenty of room to drop it in. He was so open. Pritchard has already come up with a number of big plays this season. Second and goal, 47 seconds to go in the half. 14-6, Colorado. Here's the pitch to Flannigan. Inside the five. J.J. down to the three. Burkhalter and Clifford.
When J.J. Flannigan first came to this program, he was strictly a speed back. He would race to the corner or race into openings, and has matured so much in the years he's been here. He finishes his run. He uses contact sometimes to bounce off of tackles and make guys have to really lick him to take him down.
Clock is running, 20 seconds and counting, third and goal. Flannigan, touchdown!
That's J.J. Flannigan from 2 yards out for the score.
Well, this is one that I think just about anybody in this booth could have scored. I mean, the offensive line gets a great surge. Wait where you see. For the first purple jersey, Flannigan actually wants to jump, but he realizes, hey, I don't even have to. I can walk into the end zone. And by the time the linebacker gets to him, number 53, James Clifford, it is by far too late.
Culbertson, with 16 seconds to go in the half, converts, and Colorado in the last 2 minutes has broken it open. Joe Garten really opened a hole there. He came over from the left guard spot and just peeled open the Washington defense. 47-yard drive and 1:06, and look at Garten just blow it open right there, and Flannigan behind Eric Kissick just moseys into the end zone. Clifford tackles him a yard deep, but all of a sudden, just before the half, a Colorado team with a real gutty, gritty effort. Early on, they came out, it almost seemed like they were edgy. The whole week has been so odd with the passing of Sal Aunese, and the emotion of this team has been so hard to forecast. They came out and they seemed a little bit out of kilter, but they hung with it. They played solid defense whenever Washington threatened, held them to a couple of field goals, has taken the ball away, and now all of a sudden have a 21-6 lead with just 16 seconds to go in the half. The Buffs have now run for 157 yards and have 222 yards of total offense. Coming up at halftime, Steve Alvarez of Channel 9 and Bob Palmer of Channel 4 will have a very special tribute to the late CU quarterback Sal Aunese. Plus, we'll have all the first half highlights and stats, so stay with us here.
Hope we can get a better kick from Ken Culbertson for the Buffs this time, because the last time it hurt him is Dean O'Brien got the big run back.
It's a squib kick. Washington's got it at the 33. Mark Jones fielded the ball and returned to the 33. 11 seconds to go in a half. Been a very entertaining first half, and certainly a very successful one for Colorado. I think they answered the questions, fellas, on whether or not they came to play today and whether they were emotionally ready to play.
Right, I think in the first half they've answered the question about the Washington Husky defense as well. We said Arizona got 250 yards rushing on them last year, and although they're a better defense this year, we mentioned that last year they were last in the Pac-10 in giving up rushing yards. And CU has really been able to do a good job up front. They've got a good push in the offensive line. The backs have run hard, and they've established the running game quite well.
Conklin hands it off to Compton. He's out to the 40, and Steed makes the tackle as the first half will come to an end. So a very successful first half as Colorado scored two touchdowns very late in the last 2 minutes to break open a tight game. They are now out in front, 21-6. Let's go down to Mark McIntosh.
All right, Bill McCartney is coming towards us. Coach, you've got to be very happy the way your team's playing right now.
Well, I'm happy that we're ahead 21-6. Everything that's happened out there hasn't made me happy, but I like the fact that with a wet football, we've protected it and haven't made too many mistakes. They made a good play when they deflected the ball early in the game and got the interception.
Are the kids nervous starting out?
Well, it's hard to say. I think they're emotionally charged up. And we've been able to keep them out of the end zone. That's the biggest thing that's happened.
Your defense has bent, but it hasn't broken.
Right. And now maybe if we can get another touchdown, we can dictate a different kind of game out there.
With the rain falling like this, is that going to dictate what you might do in the second half? You might be a little more conservative than normal?
Well, I think we got to get another score for sure. I mean, I don't think 21-6 necessarily going to win this game.
All right, Coach, good luck in the second half. Thank you. Coach Bill McCartney, the CU Buffs, they lead here at halftime, 21-6. Back upstairs to Ron Zavolo.
Thanks very much, Mark. Bill McCartney obviously satisfied, but not yet ready to put this one in the win column.
ABC's College Football is being brought to you by Honda, who invites you to test drive the all-new Accord at your Honda dealership starting October 5th. And by Delta Airlines. We love to fly, and it shows. We'll be right back. It's 21-6 Buffaloes at the half.
There are a number of ways to get a safer ride, like always fasten your feet belt.
Feet belt?
And never ride on worn shocks and struts. They can allow your tires to lose contact with the road, resulting in a loss of control and braking. Get a new set of Monroe Gasmatic shocks and struts. They help your vehicle hold the road.
Hey, I feel safer already.
So do I.
For a smoother, safer ride, America rides Monroe.
I used to have dandruff, so I tried Head and Shoulders. Then I tried Selsun Blue. Blue is better.
Selsun Blue relieves dandruff flaking better than Head and Shoulders. And doctors recommend it more than Head and Shoulders, Denorex, and Tegrin.
Blue is better.
Selsun Blue.
The lights on these cars are running on battery power alone. And in the end, only one, the car with a new diehard battery, our most powerful ever, is able to start. Great low prices every day, diehard power. That's your money's worth and a whole lot more.
Tomorrow.
You could get killed chasing after your fortune and glory.
Harrison Ford in the network television premiere. Indiana Jones and the Temple of Doom. Tomorrow.
Before you men go on this mission, I'm taking you to the best French restaurant in the city.
Fresh food, fresh food, fresh food, fresh food, fresh food, fresh food.
Somewhere a small restaurant is missing a big sale.
It was busy.
But U.S. West Communications can keep your small business from missing those big sales.
How about pizza? Yeah!
Find out how to protect those orders from going to the competition. Call U.S. West, making the most of your time. To the average car, this could be a dangerous body of water, even though it's only an inch deep. That hardly fazes the new four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy, the latest in foul weather gear. It weighs 1/1,000th of an ounce, yet it can take a 2,000-pound car and blow it right off the road. But not the new four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy. Think of it as a five-passenger snowmobile.
Troubled Water, a 9 News Extra on Two Forks Dam, Monday.
Husky Stadium, Ron Zappolo, Dave Logan, and myself, Tom Green, bringing you the game between the CU Buffaloes and the Washington Huskies. The Buffs, with a late surge before the half, lead it 21-6, and I think that might be the key to the game, what they did just before the half, Dave.
Well, I think certainly when you get two quick scores, it puts the opposition in somewhat of a quandary with what to do. I think CU established, again, the running game midway through the second quarter, and it's clear that they're stronger up front. They're running between the tackles, a couple of gadget plays toward the end of the first half, but right now, CU clearly in the driver's seat.
Ron Washington's going to need to come out and get something done early in the second half if they're going to get into this.
I think you're right, Tom. I think Washington now maybe has to get away from the game plan a little bit, really look for Conklin to put it in the air, and CU's got a chance, if things go well, to break this really wide open in the third quarter.
Bill McCartney seemed confident now with Mark McIntosh. He seemed like he really felt in control.
Yeah, I think he's very happy. I think he's guarding against trying to be too happy at the half, but I think he looks at the score, looks at how his kids have responded on an emotional afternoon here in Seattle. He's got to feel pretty good.
How do you measure the emotion? It was hard to forecast. Do you think the team handled the Sal Aunese situation as well as possible?
Well, obviously, they've got to be happy with the score in the first half. I don't think any way to gauge the emotion of this club. They've come out, put a good first half together, and of course, Bill wants to make sure they come out and play equally as well in the second half.
Of course, it was a week ago today that Sal Aunese passed away. Here's some special thoughts on Sal Aunese from Steve Alvarez and Bob Palmer.
March 30th, 1989. The news couldn't have been worse. Doctors told Sal Aunese he had inoperable stomach cancer.
Fortunately, I wish I could, but I can't tell you he has a 50-50 chance, or it's a 60-40 chance, or a 70-30 chance, because when you're dealing with something that's this rare, everyone responds differently. And, if there's a 1 in 100 chance, he might be that one.
He was, of course, emotional. He left the room shortly after the doctor had given him the diagnosis, returned to his room, spent some time with his family, and then spent about 15 minutes alone with Coach Mac, after which I went in and spoke with him, and he was handling the situation very maturely.
So instead of preparing for his senior season as the Buff starting quarterback, Sal Aunese began his battle against cancer. Doctors started him on chemotherapy. Aunese took over the starting quarterback role in the third game of the 1987 season as a sophomore against Washington State. His finest moment came on September 17, 1988. His one-yard run capped an 85-yard drive as the Buffaloes rallied to beat 19th-ranked Iowa. It proved once again that Sal Aunese was a leader. Throughout his battle with cancer, Aunese remained a leader, demonstrating great courage. He was an inspiration to his teammates.
Well, the mood is pretty much high spirit. Sal wouldn't want us being depressed. And so, we're keeping him in our prayers and praying for him every day. But we're just going out here, we're thinking about him, and we just want to enjoy him. We're dedicating the season to him.
Last April, he was at the annual spring game, and he made a promise to his teammates then.
God bless and see you next year.
This fall, he kept his word, visiting with his teammates during several practices and watching all three of their games so far this season. Even though he was in the stands, he wasn't forgotten by the players on the field. On the Buffs' first series against Illinois last Saturday, Jeff Campbell caught a bomb for 73 yards. The crowd at Folsom Field went wild, but Jeff Campbell blocked it all out. He was waiting for a signal from his teammate in the stands.
He's still that inspiration that everybody looks up to. He's the kid that brought this team together last year.
Afterwards, the network announcers named Sal Aunese the player of the game for his inspiration. He is gone now, but certainly not forgotten. And any greatness the CU Buffs reach this season, Sal Aunese is a part of that. He is, and forever will be, a Colorado Buffalo.
I've been fortunate to be able to know a person like Sal Aunese, to get close to him and know how he is and his strong heart and his motivation. And so I feel very fortunate to even know a guy like Sal.
The time you won your town the race, we cheered you through the marketplace. Men and boys stood cheering by, and home we brought you shoulder high. Today, the road all runners come, shoulder high, we bring you home, and set you at your threshold down, townsmen of a stiller town. Smart lad to slip betimes away from fields where glory does not stay. And early though the laurel grows, it withers quicker than the rose. Eyes the shady night has shut, cannot see the record cut. And silence sounds no worse than cheers after earth has stopped the years. Now you will not swell the rout of lads that wore their honors out. Runners whom renown outran, and the name died before the man. So set before its echoes fade, a fleet foot on the sill of shade, and hold to the low lintel up the still defended challenge cup. And round that early laureled head will flock to gaze the strengthless dead, and find, unwithered on its curls, the garland briefer than a girl's.
Say after that, not much to add except that, Sal, we know you're happy right now. We're at halftime.
I don't think there's any doubt he's as big a part of this team as anyone right now.
We're at half. We'll come back to Seattle in just a minute.
The Prudential Halftime Report is being brought to you by the companies of the Prudential. Come to the Prudential and build your future on the rock.
Dreams come true and end up with the home of your dreams, peace of mind, and a bright financial future. But in the real world, you need rock-solid investment advice, the right protection for your family, and expert help when you're buying or selling a home. So for your family's dreams, come to the companies of the Prudential and build your future on the rock.
The Pacific 10 Conference, comprised of the universities of Southern California, Oregon, California, Washington State, Arizona, Oregon State, UCLA, Arizona State, Washington, and Stanford. Unparalleled in athletic achievement and winner of more NCAA championships than any other conference, the Pacific 10 stretches from Arizona in the Southwest north to California, Oregon, and Washington. Unsurpassed in academic excellence, Pac-10 schools have been providing the best in quality education for more than a century, offering degrees in agriculture, music, art, drama, and dance, as well as the sciences, including medicine, computer science, engineering, business, and law. The Pacific 10 Conference, leading America into the 21st century.
Ron Zappolo, Tom Green, and Dave Logan back here in Seattle at the half where Colorado exploded for two late touchdowns, and they're out in front, 21-6, disappointing a crowd of somewhere in the neighborhood of 70,000 here.
I think the Gulls might be more comfortable. The rain's starting to come down. The field seemed to hold up real well. I mean, it is an AstroTurf field, but sometimes they get awfully slick. Seems like everyone's has had good traction so far.
Tell you, Tom, what I'm looking forward to is Dave Logan taping that Bill McCartney show after the ball game in a driving rain. And as I bring that up, I mean, it's only fair that we plug the Earl Bruce show on Channel 9 tonight, Dave, if you'd like to do those honors.
Yes, that will take place 11:30 on Channel 9, the Earl Bruce show. I'm not sure Tom will make it back to host, but we will do the best we can, Earl.
And then, of course, the Bill McCartney show, Sunday night with Dave Logan. And don't forget the Denver Huddle on Monday night and the Dan Reeves Show.
Anybody else we can plug? How many more shows do we have combined?
The Wonder Years, Tuesday. On that night, on that point, let's go to the highlights here, is that Colorado, down 3-0, got the lead for good on this run by Eric Bieniemy.
Well, you can see up front, an excellent job by the offensive line of turning those purple shirts away from the hole. Bieniemy breaks out of the tackle of Burkhalter. Simply a foot race into the end zone.
Bieniemy's got 66 yards at the half on 8 carries and a couple of touchdowns.
Here really is the first trick play that we'd seen, and Colorado has been big in the previous three games, coming up with something. The hook and ladder, Campbell to Pritchard, and save for the last Washington Husky, that was going to be about a 65-yard touchdown.
Set up the second touchdown of Bieniemy, and this is the airborne touchdown as he goes over the top. Watch Eric Kissick never get a look at him until Bieniemy is over the top of him in the end zone, 1 yard score.
Then a really big play that may have turned the entire game around.
Now Bruce Young gets a tremendous jump on the football. He actually saw this come and took off, as we said, before Conklin let it go. The first interception, it's actually the second interception of the day for the CU defense.
Then it's Darian Hagan following George Hemingway, and Darren Muhlenberg sets up the third touchdown just before halftime, takes it down inside the 5 before getting knocked out of bounds.
Of course, Hagan's throw to Pritchard had set up that run, and then J.J. Flannigan made it 21-6.
Follows Joe Garten into the end zone over left guard. Well, actually, that's Bieniemy again, airborne.
Trust us, though, J.J. Flannigan did make it 21-6.
Of course, that's worth two looks.
I agree. I think CU's in great shape, fellas. If they come out and just play their game, Washington will have to deviate from their game plan a little bit. It's raining, seems to have picked up harder, and Washington's going to be under the gun to get back in the game. We are at half. Colorado out in front of Washington.
We go above and beyond just like you. Above and beyond what we have to do.
I'm a Prudential representative. When I talk to people about CDs and mutual funds, they're surprised at the wide range of investment opportunities I can offer.
You work hard, so do we, to make what you've worked for a reality. The Rock, the Prudential, above and beyond.
Renowned for its programs in such fields as the biological and life sciences, international studies, fisheries and forestry, the arts, medicine, business, and engineering, the University of Washington is one of the nation's leading research universities. The University of Washington, challenging today's questions with tomorrow's answers.
We go above and beyond just like you, above and beyond what we have to do.
I'm a Prudential representative, and I help people review their life insurance needs because I know how much the right life insurance means to me and my family.
You take pride in your life, so do we. Going above and beyond is our policy. The Rock, the Prudential, above and beyond.
21-6 Buffalo as we approach the end of halftime here in Seattle, Washington at Husky Stadium, a rather wet Husky Stadium. There you see some of the fans enjoying the football today.
Probably thinking I had to pay to get in.
Let's take a look at some of the stats from the first half. CU Buffaloes. The big play is really the two turnovers that CU actually has gotten. The interceptions by Tim James, one down deep that prevented Washington from getting an early touchdown or an early score. And Bruce Young setting up the last touchdown for the Buffaloes. So I think turnovers right now the key. The Buffs coming up with a couple of key ones. 157 yards rushing isn't going to hurt either.
Well, when you come out and you establish what you do best, I think Don James said it well before the game. We know Colorado will come in and challenge our run defense. It's going to be up to us to tighten up. And so far, although they got off to a pretty good start, so far in the second quarter, Washington just didn't stop the run at all.
Don't go away. We'll be back for the second half after this.
I-
I don't worry about the quality of parts my mechanic uses. Put in whatever's cheapest, son. Heck, I'm gonna get rid of it once the ashtrays are full anyway.
Automotive technicians like your Big A Pro know quality service starts with quality parts, and your Big A Pro's got them. So look for the sign of the Big A Pro, your sign of quality parts and service nationwide.
So, how's it look, son?
You better hope your ashtrays fill up real fast.
Suffering through a cold together can be the first true test of marriage. You took your cold medicine, and he took his.
Here, keep the box.
You're not sneezing. How come you're not sneezing?
You make discoveries.
You're not coughing. How come?
And you see things you never saw before.
What have you got over there anyway?
NyQuil, the nighttime sniffling, sneezing, coughing, aching, stuffy head fever so you can rest medicine.
My poor brother Tom, every time he tried to see what he was missing, he would miss what he was seeing. Then Tom got this amazing Magnavox TV that lets him watch one show while he checks out all the others on this remarkable little window.
Hey, that's a smart window, Dick.
That's what they call it, Tom.
They call it Tom?
No. They call it smart window, Tom.
I don't know. I kind of like Tom.
Magnavox. Smart choice. Very smart.
Getting to know you, getting to know all about you.
Meet the 1990 Geo.
Getting to like you, getting to hope you like me.
In the 70s, you got to know a small car company called Toyota. In the 80s, Honda. Today, the 90s begin, and we invite you to get to know Geo.
Getting to know you.
At your Chevrolet Geo dealers.
ABC's College Football is being brought to you by Geo. Get to know Geo, sold and serviced by Chevrolet Geo dealers. And by Magnavox, smart choices for smart people. Magnavox, smart, very smart. Getting ready for the second half of play here in Seattle at Husky Stadium. The Buffaloes with a 21-6 lead, but the Huskies will get the football first. It'll be CU kicking off. Darian Hagan, 2 for 3, only threw the ball 3 times in the first half, got a couple of big plays, complete for 65 yards. Set up a couple of touchdowns right before the half with those 2 completions, and CU on top by 15.
And as Bill McCartney alluded to right after the conclusion of the second quarter, very, very important for that defense to stop 2 Husky drives. Washington was able to move the football, but they were not able to punch it into the end zone. And instead of having 14 points, they've got 2 field goals. Obviously, big, big difference.
Culbertson to kick off. Eric Alozi and Bean O'Brien are deep as we are underway in the second half. This is Alozi from the 2. And a flag is down. As Alozi is down to 25, a flag is down back at the 12.
This is just what Don James did not want to do. They're going to start from inside their own 10-yard line. And for a team that is yet to get into the end zone, having to go 90-plus yards against a defense that has prevented you from scoring at least a touchdown, it's going to be tough.
So I think important now for Kerry Conklin to come out and maybe gain some confidence back. When you make a key throw and it's a bad one and it leads to yet another touchdown, sometimes it's kind of tough to overcome, especially when you have to go in and sit for 20 minutes in the locker room and hear about it.
On the receivers, half the distance to the goal. First down.
See if we can pick up the clip here on the replay from the end zone. Number 40 driving, right, getting driven back right there. So the penalty on Corey Brown.
Scott DeGoler.
And DeGoler getting clipped, and now Washington starts from their own 8.
Conklin at quarterback. Washington trails 21-6. The handoff is to Compton. And he is down at the line of scrimmage. Joel Steed, the nose guard, the sophomore from Aurora Hinckley, made the stop. No gain, 2nd and 10.
You can see that Washington really has had very, very good field position.
That first one really hurt him when they got the turnover and gave it right back. That's a real momentum killer for the Huskies.
But I'll tell you, that last one hurt him, too.
Yeah, both interceptions were big plays. Tim James stopped them, and Bruce Young set up the final score of the half.
Rally and McKay are wide to the right. Second and 10. Here's the handoff to Lewis. Across the 10 to the 12, Alfred Williams made the stop, a pickup of three. It'll be third and 7.
In looking at Washington last week against Arizona, it seemed like if you were able to prevent them from running to one side freely, your backside pressure could be very effective. And that time, Alfred Williams came from the left side and was able to stop the play as it developed on the right side, or the offense is left and the defense is right. I'm lost.
I followed you.
Lewis had 8 carries for 44 yards in the first half. Play action on third down. Here comes the rush. Steve makes the sack back at the 6-yard line. Washington will have to punt it away. Colorado should have great field position.
They get the pressure from the top side again, and Conklin's able to spin away from the first hit here, but he looks right in as Alfred Williams goes by. Joel Steed is right there and pins him at the 7.
It's nice having a nose tackle that has the athletic ability that even when he gets blocked, he's able to bounce off and continue pursuing. And Steed definitely has great athletic ability.
Channing Miles is deep in his own end zone. Jeff Campbell at the Washington 45. Back to the 49. Down he goes to the 46. So Colorado will have good field position. 12:48 to go in the third quarter. See you out in front, 21-6.
41-yard punt. The weather around here can get messy, so people protect their homes with Georgia Pacific Building Products. Our hardboard siding puts the toughest possible protection between a house and a downpour. And GP Summit Roofing can handle 30 years of weather guaranteed, from siding and roofing to molding and doors. Every GP product has superior performance built in.
So when you're shopping for building materials, ask for GP. That's all you need to know.
For every man who wears Brut, there's a woman who loves what he smells like. Because there's something about Brute that's nice to be close to.
Honey, I was just thinking about you.
Brute, it smells like a man.
I'd rather switch than itch, so I switched to Tegrin.
Tegrin medicated shampoo controls all the major causes of itching and flaking, so Tegrin is more than strong enough for tough dandruff like yours.
Wouldn't you rather switch than itch?
The CU Buffaloes are going to start out the second half with good field position in Washington territory at the 45-yard line. Three of their 6 drives so far have started in positive field position in plus territory on the Husky half of the 50.
And here, if you're the Washington defense, I think you have to be more aggressive. You've got to gamble a little bit, making a big play.
Hagan keeps it. He's inside the 40. Hagan down the sidelines, inside the 30. Out at the 28 of Washington as Mincy drove him out. A 17-yard pickup and a first down for Darian Hagan.
The Buffs are on the verge of putting this game away as they have come out defensively, did what they had to do, and offensively come out with a big play in plus territory. Hagan gets a nice seam here. Bill Coleman with an absolute takedown, and Hagan scoots all the way down to the 32-yard line.
Good job by Jeff Campbell, too, as the wide receiver getting some downfield blocking.
Hagan 9 carries for 40 yards. Here's Bieniemy. Not much room for Eric. He's down to 28. John Cook, along with James Clifford on the stop. Look what Bill McCartney told Mark McIntosh. And in the half, if we can score one more early, we can really change and dictate what happens the rest of the game.
And certainly the Huskies are aware of that. They've had an offense that has moved the ball and yet unable to get it into the end zone. Any kind of score on this drive is big, because even if you get a field goal, you force Washington to score at least 3 times.
Kissick has it inside the 25 to the 24. John Cook again, along with Travis Richardson on the stop. Pick up a 4, 3, and 6.
It's somewhat astounding the way Washington has really had a tough time stopping CU's running attack. They played Texas A&M in the opener up here, a team that led the Southwest Conference last year in rushing, and held them to 77 yards on the ground.
This might be as good a measure as we're going to get of CU's offensive attack until they get into the heart of the Big 8 schedule.
Third and 7, and flag is down as Kissick is down, well short of the first down.
Kind of a decision here for Don James on whether to take the penalty. Apparently a hold in the traffic there. Right now at the 22, it's a 39-yard field goal. If they decline the penalty, if they take it, they give CU another crack, but they take them pretty well out of field goal range, out of chip shot range anyway.
I'll tell you this, I'm moving back if I'm Don James. You just see the signal there. Don't give him a chip shot again. That would force you to score three times. You hope that you can play good defense here on third and long and maybe keep him away from a chip shot.
On the offense, 10-yard penalty from the previous box, still third down.
Dave Logan, thinking like a coach. Who knows, someday he may be a head coach somewhere.
I would seriously doubt that. I'm a great second guesser.
It's third and 16. Ball is on the 33.
Here's where you want to just pick up positive yards, maybe half of it, give yourself a chance where you can kick a field goal.
Hagan inside the 30, gets a block from Kissick, and he's nailed at the 26.
You may be sitting at home saying, why would you run a quarterback draw third and 16, but to exactly do what we talked about, pick up at least part of the yardage and give your field goal kicker a reasonable shot of adding to a 15-point lead. Hagan bounces back. He sees an opening. Off he goes. Does a good job of securing the football. And I think a very wise play selection by Bill McCartney.
This will be a 43-yard attempt by Culbertson. Campbell to hold. He's got the distance. And it is good. From 43 yards out, Ken Culbertson stretches the lead. 10.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Colorado out in front, 24-6.
What are you doing? Hey, Dave, where'd you get that chin?
What's wrong with my chin?
Where'd you get that nose?
It's Dad's.
How do you shave under that thing?
Now there's a razor as unique as the Thomas face. The new Slim Twin razor system. Slim Twin has the slimmest cartridge to shave hard-to-reach places. And a choice of pivot or fixed head shaving.
Dave, I'd give Dad back his nose.
What's wrong with my nose?
New Slim Twin reaches every place on every face. From Schick. Today is different because today a new line of import-inspired cars has come to your neighborhood. They're called Geo. They're sold and serviced by a dealer network that's larger than Honda, Toyota, and Nissan combined. And they're designed to give you years of carefree driving. Today, the 90s begin, and we invite you to get to know Geo. They're just around the corner at your Chevrolet Geo dealer.
Let's go down to the sidelines and Mark McIntosh. Mark?
Thank you very much, Ron. Dave Logan, we might be doing the Bill McCartney Show from the floor of Husky Stadium after all. It has quit raining here in Seattle. Back up to you guys.
Well, that's great news, Mark. Thanks very much. I suppose as long as the score would stay the same way, Bill McCartney wouldn't care if he sat underneath a shower to do the show.
Attendance today, fellas, 69,152. And they're getting a up-close and personal look at why Colorado is ranked fifth and maybe going higher after today.
As we were talking about earlier, the Buffaloes really getting a measure of their rushing attack, because this is a team that has stopped a couple of teams from running the football at will, and they're having trouble with the Buff wishbone.
This one comes to Bryan at the 7. Out to the 28.
And now Washington offensively has really got to concentrate on getting the football into the end zone. They're 18 points down. Still plenty of time. If you're Don James and staff, you don't have to panic yet. You're certainly concerned with your inability to stop the CU offense. But as the Washington offense comes on the field, they have got to answer the challenge here. Move the football and put points on the board. And it can't be field goals.
One thing they've been able to do so far as well, as you see they've more than doubled the Huskies in rushing yards, is they've been able to pretty much take the James Compton out of the offense. He's in there now, but you're not going to see a lot of fullbacks over the middle for the rest of the way for the Huskies.
First and 10, the ball is on the Washington 29. Conklin, with time, goes over the middle to Ames, complete to the 35. 6-yard pickup, second and 4. You make a good point, Dave, that you're not out of this game yet, and you have to try to get it back all at once. There's plenty of time.
Makes it tough, though, in a passing offense when you obviously have to throw the majority of the time. Pretty good job up front by the Husky offensive line. They lost three starters last year to the National Football League. Done a good job of rebuilding. That's the job that Keith Gilbertson has taken over.
Colorado getting a little more per pass than Washington. Here's Lewis. Outside to the 39, where Alfred Williams makes the stop. Williams, the junior out of Houston. Conklin is 9 of 18 for 66 yards. Washington has a first down.
You know, the CU defense has not allowed a touchdown this year after the first quarter. Been pretty impressive in the first three contests. Open with Texas with great pressure. Played CSU and didn't do a very good job in the first half. Came back with a sterling performance against Illinois.
On first and 10 from the 39. Cotton over the middle, complete to Mark Jones out to the 46. Pickup of second. It'll be second and 3.
See you playing a passive defense now with that 18-point lead. They went with a three-man rush there. Got no pressure. Conklin had time to examine all of his options. Finally picked out Mark Jones over the middle. And I like the aggressive defense. I like taking the lead and doing something with it. I think you attack Conklin and you see if he can make the proper decision under pressure instead of going with the three-man rush.
It's a good point. I think as Washington progresses down the field, you'll see CU bring 3, 4, and sometimes 5 guys.
Conklin throws to Lewis, and he drops it. At the Colorado 47, it'll be 3rd and 3. Just dropped it. Aaron Simple.
I'll tell you one thing Kerry Conklin does, and I'm not sure you're going to be able to get away with it the entire year, as we take a look at Lewis. He eyeballs that receiver, but he was locked on Lewis the entire way. No reason for Lewis to come running in past the numbers there. Just hook up, present a target, and it's a much easier throw. If you're on the run, you can't adjust to a ball that's thrown behind you as it was, thus the incompletion.
8.5 minutes to go in the third quarter, 24-6 Colorado. On 3rd and 3. Conklin throws, and it's a first down to Riley. He's down to the Colorado 46. Bruce Young, along with Williams, make the stop and a first down for Washington.
That's a good sign for Washington fans. That's their first third down conversion of the game. They had been 0 for 5. They're now 1 for 6 on third down. Conklin just, like you say, Dave, pretty much has his target in mind the entire way and has a wide open Riley for the first down, and all of a sudden the Huskies are at the CU 46.
I want to ask you about that in a minute, Dave, how tough a habit that is to break. On 1st and 10. Here's Lewis. Outside, across the 40, down to the 35. Jones, Gibbs, and Chad Brown all there to make the stop. When you have that type of a habit, how do you break that?
Well, it can be very, very tough. You'll break it more times than not after you throw 3 or 4 interceptions in one game and get benched. Conklin's a big, strong guy. Lewis also very capable from the one back slot. And a good job by the offensive line. Got Canavis McGee hooked inside Lewis with enough speed to turn the corner. I think offensively, a quarterback that has not had a chance to play a lot, Kerry Conklin, although played last year, really is relatively untested. At times, you're going to have bad habits.
On 1st and 10 from the 33, Conklin wants it all to McKay, and it's well out of bounds. McLuhan was on the coverage.
This is a perfect example right here. Conklin made up his mind that he was throwing that ball deep. And that's okay to take a shot or two into the end zone. But excellent coverage by Dave McLuhan. The receiver never had a chance for the football. And I think as you continue to play, Conklin being a senior this year, you'll take what the defense gives you. And you'll stop trying to force the football into places that you just cannot get away with it.
With 7:30 to go in the third quarter, I didn't think that was such a good call, because it puts them in a situation now. Whenever they've been 2nd and long and 3rd and long, Conklin's had trouble because CU's been able to bring the house as far as getting some pressure on him. We'll see how they do here.
You can see Conklin's numbers on the afternoon. Conklin dumps it off. He was looking for Lewis. He tried to get it over the head of Alfred Williams, and got it over his head, but it was unsuccessful completing the pass.
Well, CU was messed up defensively. They couldn't decide if they had enough guys on the field. And Alfred Williams did a nice job from the outside linebacker spot of smelling the screen and actually trailing Lewis, making it a very tough throw.
Jim Hansen was lost. He didn't know whether to run on or off the field. He was the 11th man, but he was no part of the play as he was trying to run towards the Buff sideline, and the coaches were letting him know he belonged out there. So now 3rd and 10, another situation where Conklin's really had trouble. Only one third down conversion so far, but that was on this drive.
7.5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Incomplete. He was looking for Mark Jones. And we'll see what Washington does on 4th and 10.
Again, pressure up the middle forced him to throw the ball a little sooner than he wanted, and not exactly with the motion he wanted, because he was getting it right up the gut into the face and had to get rid of the football. And as we've been talking about, he's had trouble when the pressure's been there. When he's had time, he's been very effective, very efficient.
Washington will go for it on 4th and 10. No, they won't. They're going to go for a field goal attempt.
And what this does, if they are successful, it gets them back to within 2 scores with a couple of conversions on 2-point tries.
This will be a 50-yard attempt. McCallum is 2 for 3 today.
Last week he had a 47-yarder, longest in his career. He looked like he had the leg to kick it from 50 though.
On the left hash mark, and it's partially blocked into the CU end zone. The boos cascade down from a crowd of better than 69,000.
Well, not only are they booing the block, but I think they're probably booing the play selection, too.
7:14 to go in the third quarter. Colorado gets it back out in front, 24-6.
To understand Asia, you have to understand its customs, its mystery, its people. You have to know what makes a good impression and what offends. For over 40 years, we've been learning about Asia. So in addition to nearly 90 non-stop flights weekly, we can give you something no other U.S. airline can. The knowledge that comes after 40 years of helping people do business in Asia.
You won't believe the shop vac. It comes with a surprise.
So where's the surprise?
In a minute. First, this baby picks up stuff like nails and glass, and like a regular shop vac, it also picks up water.
So where's the surprise?
Just watch. You twist the top, lift it off, and you've got a surprisingly powerful blower.
And now shop vac puts its power to work cleaning carpet stains with Spot Check. It turns any shop vac into a powerful carpet cleaner. Shop vac. If it doesn't say shop vac, keep shopping.
If you keep this up, we're all going to miss the party.
Party? What party?
Oh, yeah, big bash.
Oh, party? Yeah, lots of girls.
A barbecue, chicken, ribs.
Party? Yum, yum.
And plenty of cold, natural light.
Natural light?
Natural
light. Good food and good times, it's only natural. Natural light from Anheuser-Busch.
What did you tell that guy? Told him about the party.
Party? What party?
Let's take a look at the field goal attempt again. As McCallum comes in, watch the left side surge in on the CU attack line. Salavea and Walker are going to try and see who gets the block. It looks like Salavea's left hand blocked that 50-yard field goal attempt, and now the Buffs take over at their 33-yard line.
You know, when the attempt is from that distance, more times than not, the kick is a little bit low as the kicker tries to generate enough power to get it there, and that certainly was the case.
Hagan turns it upfield across the 35, out to the 39. A 5-yard pickup by Darian. Clifford and Burkhalter, who've made most of the tackles this afternoon, combined to bring Darian down.
CU has the physical tools with this year's team to take over the clock in a game like this, where they can grind out and make just run the football consistently and see if Washington can stop them. So far, the Huskies, for the last quarter and a half, have not shown the ability to stop the CU wishbone or eye bone.
The pitch to Flannigan. J.J. with a big hole. Makes a nice move inside the 40. Down the sidelines and run out inside the Washington 25. First down for Colorado. Lilo Lang made the stop, but another big play for Colorado.
But the last time Darian Hagan tried to flip it to J.J. Flannigan, it was behind him, hitting the left shoulder pad. This time, the pitch is perfect. Flannigan very close to Hagan. Ducks up inside. Good block by Mike Pritchard. And once a kid with this speed gets into the open, does a nice job of setting up his blocks. Terrific speed. Campbell out in front trying to make a block. Of course, when you run this kind of offense, that's the one thing you must have in the backfield. Plenty of speed, and they certainly do.
Bieniemy breaks a tackle inside the 15, down to the 10. Flannigan with 38 yards. And Bieniemy. Gets a first down. Moore Calder makes the tackle.
Ron, we were talking at the half how Eric Bieniemy may lose some of his statistics and some of his Heisman candidacy power because of the balance of the CU attack. He's still an excellent running back, still one of the best in the country, but now Hagan's carrying the football, Flanagan's carrying the football. He's not going to rack up the big numbers that he needs to win a Heisman.
And what a great block by fullback George Hemingway.
Beginner Hemingway, he breaks a tackle, runs hard down to the 3-yard line.
Fellas, I think what you're seeing now is a Washington defense that is simply getting blown off the line of scrimmage. You mentioned the various weapons this CU offense has, and it's demoralizing as a defensive unit to come up with a big play on first down, second down, somebody breaks one off tackle. Here comes a fullback up the middle for positive yards. The quarterback keeps for 15 yards. Before you know it, you're out of the game, not only physically, but mentally as well.
If CU can get in here, it may be time for one of you two to start the singing. Hagan, touchdown.
What a treat in Colorado to watch these option quarterbacks we have at the college level. Darian Hagan has come on, and he's made some great decisions this year. Of course, D. Dallas down at the Air Force is marvelous to watch. But this guy is so quick and so dangerous that he just scares the dickens out of defenses. Situations like that, he really makes it look like an easy game to plan.
No doubt about it. Hagan down the line of scrimmage with the fake to Hemingway. You see a good job by John Perrick, Bill Coleman. An excellent block again by Mike Pritchard, who is virtually an unsung hero. Hagan dancing into the end zone untouched.
Culbertson on with a conversion. 5 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. It's all Colorado.
Welcome to Lumina Sedan. It has been designed with care for you and yours. With rear doors that open wide, plenty of room for the family to enjoy. And even Scotchgard fabric protector comes standard. The family Lumina sedan. When it comes to new ideas, nobody's winning like.
Heartbeat of America, that's today's Chevrolet.
Want to stay in touch? You can't beat the full line of Uniden scanners and CB radios.
Whichever you choose, choose Uniden.
Before you even touch this camera, you're going to want to own it. The incredible 35mm Infinity Super Zoom 300. From Olympus.
Part of this big crowd may be on their way home as Colorado is up 31-6. Let's go down to the sidelines to Mark McIntosh.
Thank you, Ron. The Colorado coaches are cheering on their team, encouraging them to keep up the intensity, because the more impressive this victory, and it's very impressive right now, 31-6, but the more impressive it gets, the higher they can rise in those national rankings. Back upstairs.
That's something to talk about. This team is not only going into its Big 8 season with a chance to win the Big 8 and go to the Orange Bowl. With the win today, if they go to the Orange Bowl, the odds are they will go to the Orange Bowl with a shot at the national championship. If they beat out Nebraska and Oklahoma, go to Miami, this is a team with unlimited dreams right now.
That's a great point. A couple of big ifs, but this game for sure puts Colorado really, I think, on the map nationally. I mean, the other wins were impressive, but they were home wins. And to come in here with the kind of things that have happened in the last week, and not just win, but to win in the fashion that Colorado is winning right now, that will catch national attention. Zalozzi brings it out, and he's hit. And down.
I tell you, they've got to find volunteers on some teams that return kickoffs.
That was Mike Motley on the tackle.
That's a pretty good reason as to why. You get guys running down 100 miles an hour. Don't care who they hit, as long as it's in a purple jersey. And now, again, we said the last drive, Kerry Conklin having to get something going. you just want to get some first downs. You just want to generate some offense and try to get it out of your own end if you're Washington.
They may have a personal foul roughing the passer back at the 13, which would nullify a tremendous hit by McGee.
That McGee hit looked an awful lot like Carl Mecklenburg on Marcus Allen a couple of years back, but penalty is going to nullify it. Real late hit here. Not a good play because they had Conklin in trouble.
Looks like it's on Arthur Walker. Let's take a look at it. Conklin, of course, having to throw the football, and you'll see Arthur Walker, number 83, come from the left side of your screen. And he gets Conklin pretty good. Actually, just a shove, an unnecessary shove, because the ball had obviously been thrown.
Not a good play. Not a heads-up play at all.
Roughing the passer. It's a tack on. Automatic first down.
You know, Lewis doing a great job of hanging on to the football.
Oh.
And that's what's going to happen when you get involved in a situation like this. 25 points down. You've got linebackers sitting back in zones waiting for running backs to cross through their area. And he certainly did.
5 minutes to go in this third quarter. 31-6 Colorado. They broke it open in the final 2 minutes of the first half, and it's been all CU since then.
CU's safety is now 15 yards off the ball. James and Young.
Got an official's timeout on the field.
Got to check the replay on that one, I think, Ron?
Don't give them any thoughts.
I think they're examining the spot because it was a tack on to where the reception was made. So they're just making sure they have the ball in the right place on the field. Actually, it was a problem with the clock. They have taken a little time off.
CU returns tonight at Stapleton, I believe, at 11:30. They get ready for Missouri next week. And it's incomplete. He was looking for Riley. McLuhan was on the coverage.
Conklin got put on his back by Arthur Walker again.
This is why you don't like to be behind as a running back or a receiver and have to run into a zone defense, because you'll pay the price. And Lewis running away from the quarterback. Oh, that's dangerous. And hello from Canavis McGee. That's a terrific catch.
Of course, Canavis McGee, only 6'5 and 240.
Only.
Just a boy.
Second and 10. Here comes the rush. Conklin is down. Alfred Williams, McGee's buddy on the other end, makes the sack, and Canavis and Alfred celebrating together. As it's fun to play defense when you're up 31-6.
It's fun to play defense. It's not so fun to be an offensive lineman, because obviously you can't run the ball anymore. Washington came out and ran the ball effectively in the first half, but now they've been forced to throw. I mean, Conklin can't even set on the seventh step before Alfred Williams and Joel Steed are there. Arthur Walker has spent much of the second half in the backfield, and defensive linemen really get an opportunity to shine in situations like this.
Third and long. Conklin's incomplete. Looking for Mark Jones as the Huskies will have to punt with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter, and Colorado now comfortably out in front.
Right, if this were Monday Night Football some 15 years ago, I believe Don Meredith might start to hum a few bars.
Once I saw the touchdown down here, I was waiting for one of you to.
Ooh.
Channing Wiles, second punt of the afternoon. Jeff Campbell is deep. Campbell, 13th in the nation in punt returns, averaging 14 yards a return. This punt shorter. Campbell calls for and makes the fair catch at the Colorado 39.
It'll be interesting to see when Bill McCartney starts to get some experience for some of the guys down the depth chart, start working on getting some players some time as they head into their Big 8 schedule next week against Missouri.
Don't forget, you only have two more chances to catch the Buffs at Folsom Field this season. Tickets for the Missouri game on October 7th and the Kansas game on October 21st are still on sale. Call 492-BUFFS, that's 492-8337 to get your Buff tickets now. The enemy. Out to the 43. James Clifford and Dennis Brown. Boy, Dennis Brown, even in defeat, all over the field.
Dave, where do you stand on putting the big scores up like Nebraska and Oklahoma have done to improve their national rankings? I see you as in a situation today and maybe it's some other times this year where they're good enough where they can hang a big number. Are you for that or do you think you got to draw a line?
No, I'm really not. Tell you the truth, CU hasn't had many chances to do that. I would guess should they score here, you'll probably see a lot of substitution. But no, not in college football. I think in pro football, you beat them as bad as you can.
Here's the reverse to Campbell. Just got some room down the sidelines. He's only got one man with a possible angle. Touchdown.
Turn out the lights. The party's over.
Thanks, Dandy. 57 yards. This one is O-V-E-R.
You know, that's his sixth rushing touchdown of his career. They've all come on that reverse, and no matter how often they run it, teams still seem to bite on him. I think if I were a defensive coordinator and I saw him going motion back like that, I would kill the guys if they didn't come around and seal that corner.
By the time they see him come back, it's too late. You talked earlier about the misdirection play, the first chance that we've had the opportunity to see one, Campbell, easily into the end zone.
It's interesting when you think of some of the players who were closest to Sal Aunese, you think of players like J.J. Flannigan with a touchdown, Campbell now with a touchdown, Oakland Salave has blocked the field goal. They really have responded for their friend.
Well said.
Take a look at it. Washington just been getting knocked off the ball. I mean, everybody in purple is running to the right, and here comes number 84. Key block by John Perrick, the tight end, knocks the last Husky, who really had a chance to catch Campbell, off of his feet. Bill Coleman out in front. Here's Mike Pritchard hustling down. Eric Kissick, the fullback, leading the convoy. Campbell with a nice dip back inside. That was a well-conceived play. And again, when you get a defense that's really being dominated by your offensive line, they send everybody to the point of attack, and that time it cost them dearly.
Stay with us. We're going to see a lot of people that normally don't get a chance to play here in this fourth quarter.
A peek at the future for a lot of the younger players in the program, and there are some good young players here.
Scary thing about it, a peek at the future might very well be a look at the starting units, both offensively and defensively, because this is a club that still is relatively young. They've got five seniors that start in the top 22.
Still got 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Alozi from the three. Out across the 30 to the 32. Mike Motley again. Two straight tackles for Mike Motley on special teams. Four plays, 61 yards. Didn't take a lot of time.
CU with 314 yards rushing. And of course, with the score 38-6, the game clearly in the hands of the Buffaloes. But when they rush for over 300 yards, they are 22-2.
It's going to be a happy plane ride back home. You understand Toronto beat Baltimore today to win the American League East, so all four divisions are now set. Pass to Riley. Young and McLuhan make the tackle at the 40, a pickup of seven, second and three.
Tactically, you get a look at what CU did today against Washington, and you begin to see what talent can do. This is not a victory by game plan. This is a victory by brute strength, by being bigger and faster, and playing as a team. And while Bill McCartney and the coaches, I'm sure, did a fine job in game planning the game, CU just has more talent.
This may also be one of the more emotional victories of the last couple of years for this team. You can imagine what each player felt inside on first down. Lewis across the 45. The ball's loose, but the referee says it was down. Alfred Williams made the stop. Ball is out to the 46.
Greg Lewis in the running game pretty much been taken out of it as they trail 38-6. He's starting to lose the ball, but is down before it comes out. He started to lose the grip on it. and the Huskies keep the ball at their own 46.
I tell you, fellas, the crowd has thinned down appreciably. Take a look at some of the people leaving for the...
Well, sitting in the rain's one thing when your team is in it or ahead, but sitting in the rain when you're down by this margin is just not going to cut it here in Seattle.
And it's clearing up.
That's because people are leaving. They want to go out to their boats.
Go kayak home.
Or go to the Kingdom and catch the Mariners and Twins.
Yeah, that would be a big one.
If they're really into pain.
They're going to have to figure out here whether the offensive line moved first. It looked like CU actually initiated by coming off sides, but a tackle, the left tackle, did move for Washington afterwards.
Boy, what a beautiful setting,
isn't it?
Offside defense.
Say the left tackle.
Actually, the tight end, Bill Ames, picked up.
Yeah, number 70 rocked back.
Adam Cooney.
No. Sapele Malamala.
Well done, Dave.
Well versed on those names.
You were up late last night studying those names.
Indeed.
Come through. So Washington, on the short end of a 38-6 score, has it first and five, the ball on the CU 49. To Riley. Makes a move, but McLuhan wraps him up around the neck at the Colorado 42. That should be enough for a first down.
You can see CU way back in coverage, forcing Washington to throw underneath, which was the game plan coming in. One thing about receivers, even those that are nifty, they can't run anywhere without their neck. Dave McLuhan with an arm tackle around the collarbone.
Spoken from a man who's, I'm sure, been tackled that way many times.
You can give and take that leg, boy, but that neck, that's got to go with you.
First and 10. Conklin. Down the sidelines. Yes, fine catch by Riley. I think it was tipped and Riley held on. Tim James made the stop.
Terry Conklin has been struggling today, but he throws into some coverage here and puts it into one spot. And a nice catch here as he goes up and gets it in traffic right past Tim James. And all of a sudden, the Huskies are down at the 16.
Pretty good job there by Conklin, throwing the ball where David Gibbs couldn't fall off back into the flag route and deflect it before the safety could get over to help.
They're going to get to move the ball in the air now. See who's playing a prevent most of the way now. The safeties and corners well off the line.
On first and 10, this is Lewis. Not much. Down he goes at the 15. Bruce Young with help from Salavea. See, I think Salavea, under the situation, had a heck of an afternoon.
Different people react in different ways. Situations like this, and I think being a team seemed to help all of the players on the roster. They had each other to help and support each other. And it seems like it's paid off in them getting the job done and dealing with the matter at hand today.
This will be the last play of the third quarter. Comes the blitz. Conklin gets it away. I think it was off the shoulder pad or helmet of Lewis.
And Tom, that's what we've been talking about. CU, when forced down to their end, they get very, very aggressive. Sent seven players that time.
Well, the third quarter is history. If you're a Colorado fan, you've had a whole lot of fun. Come on back, one quarter to play. Colorado out in front, 38-6.
Build and shape our future. We invite you to learn the technology of tomorrow while you serve your country in the Navy of today. If ground clearance is important in your next pickup, watch this visual test. Two full-size half-ton 4x4s, Chevy and Ford, try to drive over this protected camera cage. First, the Chevy. Plenty of clearance, but the Ford. Cameras don't lie. When it comes to half-ton ground clearance, nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America.
The heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Tomorrow.
How would would you like to babysit for me on Friday night?
I'm not supposed to leave the house.
Listen, son, it's not safe here. You can't stay.
Corky and Billy have disappeared.
Life goes on tomorrow.
To the average car, this could be a dangerous body of water, even though it's only an inch deep. That hardly fazes the new four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy, the latest in foul-weather gear. It weighs 1/1,000th of an ounce, yet it can take a 2,000-pound car and blow it right off the road. But not the new four-wheel drive Subaru Legacy. Think of it as a five-passenger snowmobile. U.S. West Communications has a question for every small business. When you have a customer on the line, who's to say you aren't missing a bigger one? Call us about adding another business phone line. U.S. West, making the most of your time.
Join us tonight for the Earl Bruce Show, live at 11:35.
Ron Zappolo, Dave Logan, and Tom Green back at Husky Stadium in Seattle. One quarter of football left. Colorado has dominated today. And they lead 38-6. Washington, though, threatening to score. They have it 3rd and 9 on the Colorado 15. Colorado broke open a 7-6 game late in the first half. Over the middle. Touchdown.
Touchdown.
Mario Bailey, number 5. First touchdown of the day for the Huskies.
Nice pattern. He runs the post, and way to hang on by Mario Bailey, because he paid for going over the middle here, Dave.
Really did. Bruce Young getting there just a little bit late with the hammer, but Bailey hangs on. He dropped a big pass last week in Tucson that could have led to a Husky victory, and that's the first touchdown that CU has given up this year after the first quarter of play.
They're going to try for 2.
They've got nothing to lose. They're down 38-12.
Bill Ames. He's shown a lot today. Catches the ball in traffic, does a nice job blocking. That was a good catch there.
So on the first play of the fourth quarter, Washington scores a touchdown for the first time. 14:55 left in the game.
Pretty good pressure again. Ames just hooking up in a dead spot, and the two-point conversion is good.
We'll return to Seattle after this.
This is a machine built for absolute dependability. And these are its hardest working parts, each meeting the highest performance standards, providing continuous, reliable service. The mechanics of American Airlines. Uncompromising professionals dedicated to perfection, flight after flight after flight.
Welcome to Lumina Sedan. It has been designed with care for you and yours.
Listen to the heartbeat.
With rear doors that open wide, plenty of room for the family to enjoy. And even Scotchgard fabric protector comes standard. The family Lumina Sedan. When it comes to new ideas, nobody's winning like.
Chad Brown, number 34, right in the middle of your screen, just looking at Conklin, trying to pick up with the eyesight where he's going. He sees Ames, actually in great shape. Ames pushes off a little bit, just like he's getting a rebound. And at 6'5 and about 240 pounds, just gets that good position, comes up with a nice catch.
9 plays, 80 yards, took him almost 5.5 minutes. Now 38-14.
Now that we're in the fourth quarter, we can probably look for some changes in the Buffalo offense. Probably see Charles Johnson getting some time at quarterback and Darian Hagan.
You see that figure, 279 yards of total offense for Washington. Keep in mind, last week against a pretty good Arizona group down in Tucson, they had 464 yards worth.
They also had a problem scoring there, 460 yards, and they come away with only 17 points, and today just 14 points to show for almost 300 yards of offense.
But again, I think largely due to the fact that they've got that three wide receiver set, and it's just tough to punch it in once you get down to scoring territory.
Callum, a short kick. That is Nelson on the 24. He's across the 30, out to the 33. Let's go down to the sidelines and Mark McIntosh.
Thank you very much, Ron. I was congratulating Jeff Campbell on his nice run, and he pointed to the sky and just looked up and said, that one was for Sal. This team is very fired up and inspired effort today, and Sal Aunese had a big part in this.
Thanks, Mark. Couldn't agree more. Say, Mark has braved the elements here, taking a beating down there, but trying to dry himself out. First and 10 from the 33. Charles Johnson in the game now at quarterback. 5'11", 165-pound sophomore out of Detroit. You can see Colorado making a few moves. Kissick was the ball carrier. Colorado with some different people in there. Nelson, O.C. Oliver, number 5. Kissick, Charles Johnson, a quarterback. J.J. Flannigan, number 2.
Nice to see that they leave the first offensive line in. Even when you substitute in the backfield, you want to make sure that you don't miss any big blocks up front that get somebody nailed.
Here's J.J. Balls across the 40 and just dives to about the 44.
What a job the offensive line has done today, putting all these yards up, especially, have we heard Dennis Brown's name called that often? Dennis Brown has really been neutralized by an offensive line that's as big a part of the CU attack as any facet that the talent positions bring. They just can go straight ahead against any line in the country and move them off the football because of their size and strength, and they play very well as a unit.
What do you think's going through his mind right now?
Get these 14 minutes over as quickly as possible.
Here's J.J. Flannigan again. Across the 45, out to the 48. Chico Fraley, number 39, made the stop on J.J., a 5-yard pickup. Second and 5.
It's a good point when you talk about option football. The great Oklahoma teams, you go back in the early 70s and beyond with Texas, Air Force, in this particular era, they all have outstanding offensive linemen that sustain their blocks. And certainly Colorado has done an excellent job up front.
J.J. now a workhorse as he's into Washington territory at the 47. He'll be about a yard short.
I'll tell you what, excuse me, Ron, when Dennis Brown and Mark Vanderpool line up over each other, there's about 13 feet and 600 pounds worth.
That's a curvature of the earth problem right there.
Two big guys.
Don't get in the middle.
Actually, a lot of times they have just let Dennis Brown rush upfield. Just let him into the backfield and figure they'll dispatch with him there.
Saw a shot there of Darian Haken. He's done for the afternoon. He can relax and cheer his teammates on. Johnson keeps it. Cuts it up. He's got a first down and more. Down the sidelines, inside the 20. 25 make it, where Leo Lang knocked him out. Another Colorado first down.
A little late hit, I thought, there from Lang. Especially this late in the game, you think the refs would be telling him not to do that. Game's a 38-14. Let's see how far out of bounds he goes here on the 23-yard carry. Charles Johnson with a nice speed to get to the corner. Neil Lang catches and couldn't really see where the sideline was there, but drills him out of bounds. Bumps knocking on the door again at the 24.
You know, nice to see Charles Johnson get a chance to play, because should something happen to Darian Haken, Johnson, this is much needed playing time for a second-string quarterback.
The pitch to Flannigan. He's down to the 22. John Cook, along with James Clifford, making the stop.
He's got those happy feet.
Yeah, he does.
Real quick feet. J.J. Flannigan, the long strider, who said earlier, really a finesse player when he got there. He's added 12 pounds in the offseason.
Wouldn't you think J.J. is going to be a pretty high draft pick?
Oh, I definitely do. First of all, when you got a guy that runs 4.3 in the 40 at 195, you've got the makings of a very good pro player, and he's really come on this year. He's established himself as a viable threat in the tailback position.
Even though he's not the starter, he's going to rack up a lot of yards as he's down to the 20. James Clifford, John Cook making most of the tackles, 53 and 93. Bill McCartney probably already thinking about next week as he paces the sideline.
They've now run for 362 yards and just grounded out. They've thrown the football three times today, completed two of them. They just haven't had to.
It's third and five. Here's Flannigan. Down to about the 16. He's going to be short by a couple of yards. Chico Fraley made the stop. See what the Buffs decide on fourth and a couple.
That was a play that it looked like it was going to develop into a first down, and Flannigan just more or less ran right up the backs of his lead blockers. Not a lot of room to go, and J.J., I think, making a correct decision to try to barrel his way to the first down.
CU will go for it on fourth and one. 10:37 to go, and the clock running.
This is a situation there on that nifty little play where just the center and quarterback shoot off and everyone stays.
Except there's a guy right over the center this time.
Johnson's got it. And he's got the first down and the touchdown.
I'll tell you what, if we can focus on Eric Kissick, you know, fullback doesn't always get that many opportunities to run the football. You can watch Charles Johnson, but watch number 33, Eric Kissick, as he comes through the line. He's looking for somebody to knock down. Watch who he finds. He's going to be out of your screen. Kissick, I mean, turns the guy upside down, and Charles Johnson with a nice decision on the option for yet another score.
The right tackle, Mark Vanderpool, got a great stalemate in the situation. That's all they needed. Allowed Johnson and company to turn the corner 16 yards for the touchdown, capping a 53-yard drive. Or no, 53 yards for Johnson so far carrying the football.
Culbertson converts. Think this score is going to lift a few eyebrows around the country tomorrow morning? 10:21 to go in the ball game. Colorado just continues to extend that lead.
Made up my mind. I'm gonna do it. Why shouldn't I? I'm the one who has to look at myself in the mirror every morning. So before I lose another hair, I'm going to the doctor. I know doctors have treatment programs that are proven to work. More guys are trying them every day. I'm not bad now, but I wouldn't mind looking better.
Your doctor can really do something about hair loss. So see your doctor or call this toll-free number.
If you want power, if you want performance power, don't just pump. Pump up. Pump up to Super Clean Premium. Performance power from Phillips 66.
We talked about the play of fullbacks in option football. They look for people to hit. Watch Eric Kissick, number 33, as he finds the all-packed-in cornerback Leo Lang in the air. He'll go down too, but so will Leo Lang. Kind of a stalemate there. Both players hit the ground. You need people downfield looking for guys to block. Instead of 5, 6, 7 yard gains, you get big plays all the time in option football. And it can sometimes be laborious as a blocker to go down. I'm throwing my body, I'm not getting anything, but you never know when a big play can happen. And Kissick's one of the best they've had at doing that.
Gotten great play from the fullbacks today. Both Hemingway and Kissick have really done the job and been a big part of the big number they've had rushing the football.
It's kind of hard to imagine another collegiate team with any more weapons than Colorado has at the skill positions. This one to Alozi at the 8. Right up the middle, across the 30, out to the 38 with James and McLuhan. Make the stop. So a good return by Alozi. 8 plays, 67 yards. Charles Johnson takes it over on fourth down.
As a head coach, you always look for something you can work on in the upcoming week, and even when your team has played very, very well on the road. Bill McCartney, I'm sure, will be talking to the special teams and especially the kickoff coverage.
We're going to get a good look at a freshman here who's a big play player, they think, on the defensive line. Marcellus Elder, number 97, in for the Buffs on the defensive line. See what this young freshman has. He's very, very big.
Buffs have a lot of second-team defensive people. We'll get them to you in just a minute. As Conklin on first down. Got got rid of it. Davis McGee was putting the pressure on Conklin, and Conklin threw it away.
Well, Conklin's a good quarterback, but he's just like other good ones. If you start to pressure him and you continually harass him and you knock him down a few times and you tip his passes and you knock his receivers down, he gets frustrated and he starts to want to throw the ball before receivers are ready, before he sets his feet.
Greg Thomas, 27, Julian Hayward, 26, both in there now for Colorado.
Up almost 9 yards of play on offense. It's amazing.
Incomplete is
Arthur Walker with a wonderful spin move, came pouring in on Conklin right as he released it. He just unloaded it to a place he thought no one would be, because Walker certainly tacked one on Conklin there.
10 minutes to go in the ball game.
Tough duty for quarterbacks who have to catch defensive linemen after they throw the ball. Eric Kissick, another player that was very, very close to Sal Aunese. Had a good game.
As have most of the Buffs who played today. Conklin completes it to Lewis. Lewis did a good job after the catch and got it to the 40, where Hayward and David Brown, number 32, made the stop with a first down for the Huskies.
Looked like a blown coverage as Conklin again gets hit after he releases the football. You can see Arthur Walker in. Two CU defenders on the outside. And Lewis, very good receiver, out of the backfield, and able to run the drag inside and opens up for a big play.
Is okay, fellas. He's coming off like he might be shaken up a little bit.
Well, he caught the tip of the football in the lower abdomen, I think.
Second interception of the day.
That doesn't feel good. We're not laughing at you, Bruce. We're snickering with you. Ball overthrown. You can see. Oh, my. Yes. Although, I tell you, I think he would sacrifice most parts of his body for an interception. At least defensive backs would.
Not right now, he wouldn't.
Oh, goodness. Bruce Young, another player that's had an exceptional game.
Here's the handoff to Oliver. You can laugh when you're up 45-14. Mike Lustig.
But you can laugh when you're in the booth and not down there suffering from the pain.
But he's going to be okay in a minute or two. That's his second interception of the ball game. And of course, he's a leader. He's had a great game. Everybody who's ever played sports has had that happen one time or another.
Unstoppable in the second half on offense.
That they've been.
I mean, they haven't scored the last two times they had the ball in the first half.
They haven't even slowed down, really.
It's Matt Bell. Nice spin. Spin, you're right. After the 32. Lustig again.
Actually on the ball carrier.
8:40 to go and counting here, as it has been all Colorado. As you look at George Hemingway, what a great first half, fellas, Hemingway had. I thought he really kind of set the tone early in the ball game with the aggressive style of play he brought today.
He made some nice reads a couple of times, just taking the ball from Darian Hagan, doing the reading himself and getting it done.
Third and seven for the Buffs. Here's Bell out of TJ. Nice run by Matt. He's out to about the 37, where I think he'll be a yard short. Colorado will have to punt. Eric Briscoe made the stop. Last man up off the pile.
Do you think, regardless of how many points they score or how many they win by, they've now reached a point where someone's going to have to lose in front of them for them to bump up in the standings? I don't see him being able to leapfrog anyone unless someone gets beat.
Well, the good news is Nebraska currently in front of them. They'll have their opportunity to dislodge them from a spot in front. I think Clemson lost them. So they're going to have a chance, certainly, to advance.
Ruin drives Mincy back to the 13. And Mincy is down as Lamar Gray made a nice open field tackle on Mincy. 7:31 to go. The celebrations have started here in Seattle as Colorado in a blowout.
heartbeat, the heartbeat of America.
For today's work, today's world, Chevrolet will introduce more new trucks in 1990 than anyone else anywhere. Nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
The heartbeat of America. Today's truck is Chevrolet.
Heineken. Amstel Light.
This
so
is
much
it.
Better than
it's
other light beers.
It's a great imported beer.
A delicious European
nothing compares
taste.
To the smoothness,
a refreshing,
the richness, or the character.
Distinctive
of
flavor that cuts through
its
your thirst.
Its quality comes through.
There's a uniqueness to it.
Heineken is America's number one selling imported beer. Amstel Light is America's number one selling imported light beer. Why? Just ask the people who drink them.
In my opinion, Amstel Light is the best beer there is.
I could go on and
say enough about it. It's a light beer.
No matter how many beers you're.
No problem. That's been the story for Colorado today. No problem.
Wonder if they can find a water channel all the way back to Denver.
Isn't that kind of a nice picture? I've had a chance to spend time up here. Been out on boats like that. I can't think of a more relaxing way to spend a weekend.
But you were married up here.
That's right. That's right.
That's a relaxing way to spend a weekend.
The jury is still out, Dave. First and 10 is Conklin. Hits Lewis over the middle. He's hit by half of the Buff defense. Balls out to the 24. Great spot to get married. I'll tell you, it's a beautiful area. For people back home who have not been to the Pacific Northwest, it is one of the prettiest areas of our country.
Sure is.
Get a great tan here.
I may be in some trouble now on the way home. 7 minutes to go here in the ballgame. 45-14. All Colorado. On the delay, this is Lewis. It's a nice run. Julian Hayward finally makes the tackle. Lewis out across the 30 to the 31. Well, we got a minute here. Really, once again, we really didn't belabor the point, but we certainly want to tip our hat and thank Channels 9 and 4 for getting together and making it possible to bring this game back to Colorado. And I'm sure a lot of football and Colorado fans were happy with the fact that everybody got together and was able to do it.
Bottom line is the viewers got to see it. Doesn't matter who has the game as far as the viewer is concerned. They just want to see football.
Conklin going up top. Hamilton was there. The ball was intended for Riley. Because Bruce Young is retired with those two interceptions.
I don't blame him.
Bill McCartney gets to go up against his alma mater next week, Missouri. And Missouri, maybe not this year, but with Bob Stull there in a couple of years, he's going to be a force in the Big Eight. He turned around a pretty sad program at UTEP.
Bob Stull, the former assistant coach here in Washington.
Conklin way over the head of Mark Jones.
And when you see that picture right there, you know as an offensive player, it's been a long day. That quarterback has been getting up on just about every pass attempt. Conklin trying to find somebody open. As we told you, he's been catching a lot of white jerseys after he throws the ball, and that is no good for a guy at that spot. Down he goes again.
Jim Hansen in there.
Not a lot of fun to be an offensive player when you're just getting blown away. And how much you can do, Conklin. Riley crossed the 40, looking to get it to that marker.
Yeah, almost 10. Almost gave up the first down. Trying to make a big play out of it. I think may have been able to reach across the line.
I think he's got enough.
You see Andre Riley trying to make something big happen. Ducks inside. Now he's thinking, how can I get away? And right here he realizes, uh-oh. Does a nice job of getting the first down.
Conklin now 19 of 37 for 138 yards. Quite a letdown from the numbers he was putting up last week against Arizona.
Miami and Michigan State in East Lansing tied 20 all.
Conklin. Again to a wide open Orlando McKay. Run out of bounds by Greg Thomas. But they've got it at
at the 26.
The importance from a corner route that as a cornerback, you reroute that receiver. And that time you can see number four, Orlando McKay, simply getting behind Eric Hamilton, untouched, and it's pretty easy throw and catch.
One of the few times they got Conklin time to throw the football without having to hurry it up, someone coming at him.
Conklin throws complete to Bailey, and incomplete, or they call it a fumble. It's the touchdown. It was complete, fumbled, and recovered for a touchdown. Ames recovered.
Harry Conklin starting to get it done against the second team CU defense. Here he finds Bailey in the seam. And as Bailey is making his way into the end zone, the ball is knocked out there on the collision. It goes into the end zone. Bill Ames then, Johnny on the spot, recovers the tight end. It's a 25-yard pass, a 1-yard fumble for a touchdown. And once again, the Huskies are going to go for two.
Throws it, and the conversion is good. Andre Riley with the conversion. 5:38 to go in the game. Colorado 45, Washington 22.
America was built on dreams, and business is the key. We ensure where America.
Wood finish for beautiful color like no other, and Minwax polyurethane for fast drying protection that lasts.
I have the perfect remedy for your heartburn with headache.
Oh, I can't take Alka-Seltzer.
This one's different. New advanced formula Alka-Seltzer.
Boy, that tastes great.
See?
But it's not Alka-Seltzer.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Of course it is. Yes, no, it is. Yes, of course it is.
New advanced formula. Believe it or not, it's Alka-Seltzer.
No, it isn't.
The thing that is most impressive about this throw, it's delivered right on time. One, two, three, four, five. Fifth step, ball's gone. Chad Brown never has a chance to look for it. Mario Bailey catches it, fumbles, and it results in a touchdown. And Tennessee has knocked off the fourth-ranked Tigers of Auburn, which bodes well for the CU Buffaloes.
Well, CU will go at least
one notch.
Oklahoma beat Kansas 45-6.
Sooners seem to have made their transition pretty smoothly outside of the loss at Arizona. It seems like they're thumping the teams they should thump in their standard fashion. It's going to be interesting to see what kind of emotion the Sooners play with this year, knowing they can't do so many things. They can't be on national TV, and they can't go to the bowl game, and they can't win the conference title.
Mike Pritchard on the return. And he's thrown backwards by Charles Mincy and nailed back at the 15. It pains Bill McCartney as Pritchard reversed his field and got thrown for a loss. Still 5.5 minutes to go. This fourth quarter has really kind of dragged along.
Not that it's too important at this point, but this is the poorest field position that the Buffaloes will start in the second half with. 16.
Charles Johnson still at quarterback. Michael Simmons in the game. He's out to the 19.
Simmons playing tailback. He had moved up to third string fullback and then asked to be switched. Was a starter a couple of years ago at fullback.
Had a big year.
This goes to show you how many, as you mentioned, Ron, how many running backs this club has. They go three or four deep. Had a couple of spots.
Mark Henry, sophomore wide receiver, checks in. Tony Sennett, number 30, is in the game, along with O.C. Oliver and Simmons. Johnson keeps it. Good open field tackle by Mike Allman, number 16, the free safety. After an 8-yard pickup by Johnson, and a first down for Colorado.
On the field, things have gone so smoothly for this team so far this year. What do you think of the problems that they're going to have to avoid, the pitfalls, Dave?
Well, number one, I think something they can't control is injuries. You don't want to get key guys banged up. If Hagan should go down, although Johnson's a capable replacement, it really hurts the team. And I think now that you've got to make sure that you stress the good things, but equally you want to point out the bad things that they've done, the kickoff coverage, because you've got some very important football games still remaining on the schedule. I think everybody agreed that this was a very important game, and should the CU come out and play well enough to win, that they do have a legitimate chance to go to the Orange Bowl, Tom, as you mentioned, and play for the national championship. I see no reason why you can't dream a bit, and that is a distinct possibility.
Mark Walters, fellas, checks into the game at quarterback. Mark, 6'3", 180-pound junior from Carson, California. Pitch to Bell. He's across the 30 to the 32. Mike Allman again, along with Dave Hoffman, number 54, on the stop. We're 3.5 minutes away from the end of this fourth game for Colorado. They'll be perfect, 4-0.
Their schedule really doesn't work for them down towards the end of the season, with the three big games they're going to have to play being stacked right next to each other. The next 3 weeks, they're home against Missouri, at Iowa State, home against Kansas, and then they're at Oklahoma on the 28th. Then they get Nebraska at home on the 4th, and then at Oklahoma State, although the Cowboys look like they've fallen off a great deal from last year's team that won a Holiday Bowl.
A lot of movement on the line. Colorado with over 400 yards on the ground. If the game had been a little closer, those numbers might even be greater.
Dead ball foul. Ball start on the offense. 5 yards.
It's hard not to get carried away when you watch CU and what they've done in these first four ball games.
Their whole season probably will come down to those back-to-back games with Oklahoma and Nebraska. They're on a roll when they go into those games. As we talked about, they're capable of almost anything this year.
Brent Branch, number 20 in the game. Walters fumbles the snap, and Washington's got it. They'll take over at the 25. Travis, number 47.
The ball just goes right through Mark Walters' hands, and then as he looks for it, he just can't find the handle.
First and 10 from the Huskies, outside the Colorado 25.
If nothing else, it's going to make the score look respectable if Washington can punch this one in.
Mark Udoh, along with Travis, on the bottom of that pile, coming up with a football. Huskies have it first and 10 on the CU 26. The pass and is tackled at the 15. Sam Adkins made the stop.
The Buffs playing a very passive, soft zone, and Lewis just trotted out into an area, and it was just a quick hitter. Conklin put it right on the numbers, and they're down to the 15-yard line.
I think that Doug Adkins instead of Sam. Clock running, 2.5 minutes to go in the game. Score will not be indicative of the kind of game we saw here this afternoon, as Conklin throws it incomplete. Looking for Riley. Julian Hayward on the coverage. Clock stop with 2:21 to go. Even the Seagulls making their way out of the stadium. USC, the score was announced, just beat Washington State 18-17.
That game in Pullman, USC coming off a big victory last week. Washington State, before the game, was undefeated. Lost to fine quarterback Dawson to a thumb injury 2 weeks ago.
Conklin throws it to Riley. He's got it at the 8. Hayward and Thomas push him back, but they'll mark it at around the 7 or 8 yard line.
They've used this play a lot this afternoon, and especially against the zone defense. Wide receiver Riley just goes to the outside, stops, hooks. And you're going to be able to pick up a few yards like that when the score is as it is today.
Minute 45 to go in the game. Here's the handoff to Lewis. Big hole, touchdown.
Run by Lewis here. As I said, he's a nifty running back. He's got quick moves. He seems to slide through holes, go through them sideways and drift back, and here he makes a nice cut back, carries the football into the end zone. And once again, the Huskies appear like they'll go for two. If they get it, they're within 15 with a minute 39 to go.
They've been successful twice already on two-point conversions. McKay and Riley are wide to the right. Bailey is in the slot. Jay Berry is in motion. Conklin. And it's incomplete. Terry Johnson had a hand on it.
Gary Howe, the nose tackle, came in and got pressure, actually took Conklin down.
Got a minute 39 left in the game. We'll return in just a minute.
Ooh, honey. Don't come near me, please.
Oh, I can't. No, it's not a good idea.
Oh, no, no, baby, you know, not right now.
Oh, sweetie. You don't want to get too close.
Fight morning breath with Scope. Scope has two powerful ingredients to kill 90% of the bacteria that cause morning breath.
Kiss me.
What are you waiting for?
Great kiss.
You may kiss me now.
Scope, the best thing first thing in the morning.
If you want to move ahead in any career, you have to know what most employers want. Like how to work with a team, how to handle responsibility, how to take on a tough job and see it through. You can learn all these things in the Army. So when you do set off on the road to success, you'll already be in the driver's seat.
Here's one way to stop Kerry Conklin. He goes with a short drop on the two-point conversion. Gary Howe, the nose tackle, just comes right in, gets into his ankles, and takes him down as he throws the football into traffic. And the pass is incomplete, so it stays 45-28 as they fail for the first time on the two-point conversion.
CU is expecting an onside kick as you look at what Washington accomplished. They've got nine men up within 20 yards of the football. McLuhan, Gibbs, Bieniemy. Minute 39 to go. And here comes your onside kick.
I think it's coming this way.
What gave you that idea? It's loose.
I think Washington's going to be offside, though.
They were.
Well, Washington's got the football. And there's a flag down back at the Washington 35. And
it wasn't even close. There were a couple of guys well across the line. But last week, big Pac-10 game decided with an onside kick.
That's right.
And Don James, as I said earlier, is quite famous for his special teams play. But on the near side, you can see.
Well, they had about five guys over the line.
At least it wasn't any one player that has to feel badly about it.
They can chew everyone out in the films.
Sure. Misery loves company. CU charter due to get back at about 11:30. We will not leave tonight. About another three and a half hours after the game.
On the kicking team, 5-yard penalty.
Been a long day for Don James.
Their team falls to 2-2 after winning against Texas A&M and Purdue. They've now lost on the road to Arizona and here at home, something they don't do very often, to a Colorado team that's headed for at least the number 4 ranking.
And Washington probably loses their ranking altogether.
You know, Don James, a guy that coming off a 6-5 year last year, turned down an extension and a raise. Said, I don't deserve it. Works with a 5-year contract every year. a rollover contract that you can add a year to and just turn them down.
Here comes the onside. This time we're going to go left.
No, they are. Oh.
Let's see who has this one. And they do.
Team that might jump into the top 20 with a couple of spots opening up, the Air Force Falcons.
Apparently a big winner today. We didn't get that final score, but they were comfortably out in front.
And they've got the star potential that the voters like in D. Dallas. He certainly attracts votes for the team with the numbers he puts up.
John Perrick covering the football. A minute 35 to go. Hopefully Washington will not use the three timeouts they have left. Walters gives it to Senna. He's across the 40 down to about the 36. As the clock continues to run, Mark Goodeau made the tackle. It's hard to find anything to be critical of in this performance. Colorado just so impressive.
And it looked like it was going to get off to a bad start. They get the tip ball, the interception. They come right back with a big play on defense. And I think the tone was set for this game by the defense early with two stops. And Washington had excellent opportunities to score a couple of touchdowns. They hold them to two field goals. They never relinquished the lead after scoring their first touchdown. Of course, the second half, they simply wore out the Huskies.
Mike Allman made the stop on Senna. Clock is running. 45 seconds left in the ball game. Very few. It won't be too hard getting out of the stadium tonight, as about 50,000 of the 69,000 are already out of here. Senna thrown for a loss by Mike Lustig. That might be the final play of the ball game.
That should do it.
Okay.
And now the Buffaloes look ahead to the conference schedule.
After their non-conference record is a perfect 4-0.
And there's Oakland Salavea.
Good job. And there's Bill McCartney. Well, I take a big sigh of relief on the Colorado sidelines right now. McCartney seeking out Don James.
Real proud moment for the athletic department, the football program, and the university. They dealt with the adversity this week. They continue to give the school something to cheer for as far as a football program, but also showed a lot of character this week in coming up here.
It's Bill McCartney there hugging Mark Jones, who was a friend of Sal Aunese. So that's it. Colorado in impressive fashion, 45-28 over Washington. We'll return in just a minute.
For every man who wears Brut, there's a woman who loves what he smells like. Because there's something about Brut that's nice to be close to.
Honey, I was just thinking about you.
Brut, it smells like a man.
The lights on these cars are running on battery power alone. And in the end, only one, the car with a new die-hard battery, our most powerful ever, is able to start. Great low prices every day, die-hard power. That's your money's worth and a whole lot more.
Ladies and gentlemen, I wish my old partner was here tonight, because this used to be our song.
I have everything.
All my dreams come true.
Eddie.
You're my arms, stuck and bomb.
In the movies, happy endings are easy, but in the real world, they take solid planning. So for investment advice, peace of mind, even buying or selling a home, come to the companies of the Prudential and build your future on the rock.
In most ways, it's unlike any Subaru ever built. It's a full-size luxury compact with more horsepower than any car in its class, and the styling and amenities of a European sedan. Yet you get a feeling from this all-new Subaru that it has somehow been here before. That it has inherited a tradition of excellence in front and four-wheel drive technology. Which makes this more than our finest car. It makes this our legacy.
Ron Zappolo along with Tom Green and Dave Logan at Husky Stadium in Washington, where today it was all Colorado, and fellas, it seemed to be a slug'em, rock'em, sock'em game until the last couple of minutes of the first half when Colorado assumed control and never looked back.
Well, Bruce Young comes up with that key interception that allowed CU to score that third touchdown, and then of course with a 21-6 lead, they really seized control in the third quarter. The running game was dominant. They never let them back in the game defensively, and this game really was over about midway through the third period.
Darian Hagan showing a lot of maturity, not keeping the football, spreading it out, making the right decisions, taking the team in for the couple of scores, then in the second half really just pulling away.
Well, it was kind of an event today, and I for one certainly enjoyed it. It was a lot of fun, and who knows? Maybe we'll do it again sometime.
You're all invited back.
Oh, thank you, Tom.
So the final score, Colorado 45, Washington 28. The executive producer of today's game is Tom Edwards. Produced by Terry Trovato. Directed by Tom Richards. Chief engineer, Tom Piper. Coordinating director, Ches Rutledge. For Dave Logan, Tom Green, and Mark McIntosh, this is Ron Zappolo saying good afternoon from Husky Stadium in Seattle.
ABC's College Football has been brought to you by Today's Chevrolet, who invites you to see why nobody's winning like the heartbeat of America. And by USF&G. All across this country, USF&G protects your business, home, auto, and life. USF&G covers the USA.